software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
All whey protein powders are not created equal. Fresh liquid whey has been used for hundreds of years to restore health to the sick and youth to the aging. Why is it that no one reports these benefits from today's whey protein powders? It is because they are all processed with heat or chemicals, which damages the protein and amino acids, making them allergy-causing or toxic to your body. One World Whey's True Cool process retains all the powerful properties of fresh raw whey in a concentrated powder. My name is Stephen Heuer. As a degreed nutritionist, my goal is to make you healthy in as short a time and as affordably as possible. One World Whey is speeding up the process of helping people get healthy and is replacing the need for many other supplements, making it more affordable. To learn how One World Whey may help you with fat loss, the elimination of inflammation and pain, detoxification of heavy metals, intestinal health, brain function, and increases in strength, energy, and muscle size, call 888-988-3325 or visit oneworldway.com. That's oneworld, W-H-E-Y.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
If you want to play online poker with Bitcoin, you need a site that's trustworthy and technically sound. The site managers of swcpoker.eu have proven their commitment to bringing you great gameplay from a site you can trust, swcpoker.eu. They have lots of new games too, including Chinese poker, and their Krill leaderboard is open right now. It's a beautiful site, easy to use with lots of players. Go on over to swcpoker.eu now and have some fun with your Bitcoin. swcpoker.eu.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
It's the live Sunday edition of the program. And, of course, you can join us online at freetalklive.com. If you want to get interactive with us here on the radio, you can call us toll-free at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Offensive Halloween display. Should they be verboten? Should they be prohibited? Should someone get in trouble with the law over having an offensive Halloween display? If there are people who actually believe that, I'd love to hear from you tonight. 855-450-FREE. Also Skype it. Skype username lrn.fm.
I think that putting libertarianism, the ideas of freedom, into fiction work is probably the best way to get those ideas out. I can't do that. I'm just not talented in that way. However, there are lots of people who are, including Brandon Bitros and J. Matthew Root, who are putting out a action comedy graphic novel called James versus the New World Order. And it's going to be, you know, a 5-volume, 24-issue series. They're trying to do some fundraising for basically getting some pre-orders. And you can do that by going to jamesvsthenewworldorder.com. You help them with the pre-orders, and you get a discount. It's a great deal. So jamesvsthenewworldorder.com. They want to raise $3,000 to pay for the artwork, the coloring, the production, and the distribution. James versus the New World Order, worldorder.com.
All right. So Ian and Mark here in the studio with you tonight. Our toll-free number again, 855-450-3733. Some neighbors are saying that the anti-ISIS, the purported anti-ISIS display in New Jersey is offensive, and one lady is even claiming that it is un-American. And if you agree with her, I'd like to hear from you. I did post the story so you can see the photos over on our Facebook and Twitter. You can go to news.freetalklive.com and link over to either one of those, whichever is your preference. And there's more here of the reactions from folks. The owner of the home says that his decorations have been vandalized since he had gained media attention.
If you get the attention, then somebody's going to do the vandalizing. You know, I mean, it just, it's generally the way.
It's sad. And, you know, that is certainly un-American, disrespecting other people's property rights. This is this man's property. He should be able to put whatever he wants on his property.
A lot of people probably feel like they are, you know, they're doing the neighborhood a favor by going and doing something like this. This person is sufficiently a pariah or whatever, and so therefore going after them may drive them out of the neighborhood or, you know, cause them to change their behavior or whatever. So that's what they're doing.
The offended neighbor says, like it or not, Halloween is now viewed as a kid's holiday, and that's not a house that I would think a lot of parents would want their kids trick-or-treating at.
Maybe that's the idea. Maybe they want to save some money on candy and keep your little brats away.
He has put a ski mask on the dummy instead of the Obama mask since the controversy, but says he plans to, quote, kick it up a notch now that the reactions have been so passionate. So by being offended and by making a big deal out of this, people are bringing more attention to it and further encouraging him to make the display perhaps even more offensive as a result of that. Hey, he's getting what he was looking for, which is, in this case, international press coverage from the Daily Mail and a lot of other places. Now, let's see. He's not the only Halloween fan courting controversy. A front yard in Ohio is upsetting just as many for the gruesome fake corpses strewn all over. Even though Halloween is more than 3 weeks away, when this was written, it's now just less than that. The yard in Parma, Ohio, already contains a cocooned corpse hanging from a tree, a body impaled on a stake, and a cadaver upside down on a cross.
The body impaled on the stake, by the way, is a child's body.
Yeah, it sure is. And it happens to be close to the Densler Elementary School. Although some have said the horrific decor is...
It is horrific.
...is too much. This is much more gory than the ISIS display. We're talking about knives sticking out of the necks, and the person that is attached to the cross has been pounded. It looks like there are nails that have been pounded through their palms of their hands, if you will, or just below the palms of the wrists. So, yeah, pretty gory, plenty of blood, lots of knives.
So what do you think about kids seeing this?
You know, look, it's Halloween. I mean, it's supposed to be scary. It's supposed to be a scary time of the year as well as a fun time. The fun kind of mixes with the fear for kids, and that's part of the excitement. That's part of the exhilaration of the entire thing. If everything was just tame My Little Ponies, it wouldn't be any fun at all.
I think it's too much, but, you know, I mean, what are you going to do? I think that if my son saw it, he'd want to see, we'd stand there and we'd look at it, and I'd talk about how that's a rubber thing, and they're trying to make it look this way or that way, and, you know, I'd have a discussion with him regarding that. It's the best I could do in that
circumstance. Great opportunity to have those conversations.
Thanks for the opportunity, a-holes. See, this is a story of a-holes.
And, well, yes, and ungrateful parents.
Them too. Lots of a-holes.
Let's see here. More from the story. Although some have said the decor is too much for Halloween, others maintain the family's just having fun and their decorations are appropriate. Social media users took to Twitter to weigh in on the issue. One man said, they're fine. It's Halloween. Have a little fun with people with it. People need to get a backbone, for gosh sakes. Another gentleman said, they're decorations. That's it. People need to get a life and not blow everything out of proportion. Others didn't agree and said the decorations went too far and they were not fans of the family. People have complained to the city about the display, but Parma officials say there's nothing they can do because the family has a right to freedom of expression.
Absolutely.
Vicky Barrett and her husband may tone it down if they find out that children are being frightened. Then again, maybe not. She said, we don't want to scare kids. We just want to do...
Then again, who's raising them to be such little wimps?
Yeah. We just want to do the Halloween fun of it and, you know, but definitely no ill intent. No, she says. Meanwhile, in Detroit, a woman who's been decorating her home the same way for 25 years has created a bit of controversy because of what's in her yard. Loretha Haddon puts a stuffed body in the front yard that attracts attention each year because it's so lifelike, according to the Detroit News. The body has drawn the attention of passersby, emergency workers, and...
you got to do something with that. I'm sorry.
And even police. And it is Detroit, so... she said the corner is
it's
always...
It's just laying there. It's just laying. Holy crap.
That's great. That's good trolling.
Oh, God.
And she's been doing it for 25 years. So, you know, anybody that...
It just looks like a shooting victim laying there. Just
say, the head doesn't look the head doesn't look particularly real. It just looks like a
bedsheet. No, it's not realistic in the sense that
from far away,
right, that this body looks realistic. It's realistic in the sense that it's just this figure lying on the ground like it's dead in Detroit.
She says the corner's always full of cars, people running up trying to do CPR. Once they find out it's a dummy, it's so hilarious, says.
This lady's awful.
She started putting out the face-down body in honor of her husband's birthday on Halloween. It's drawn so much attention that Haddon has started taking the corpse in after sundown. She says if you don't bring him in at night, he won't be there in the morning. I learned my lesson. I have to bring him in at night. But on Halloween, he stays out all night. I just keep my door open until we go to bed. Our toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. What's the most offensive Halloween display that you've ever seen? And are you one of these people who creates the offensive Halloween displays? What's that been like for you? If you can share those stories, you're welcome to do so. You can also bring up anything you want. 855-450-FREE. We've got other New Jersey news about tolls. It's Free Talk Live.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Blockit Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. Blockitpocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at Blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618. Blockitpocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
The warning signs.
At first, he made me feel special. He promised he'd look after me, provide for my future. He broke every promise he made.
Millions of Americans afflicted.
I was ready to leave, but he told me he'd change. So I gave him another chance. I was such a fool.
The consequences.
Things only got worse. He started making my decisions for me about my job, my kids' education, my money. My safety, my future. He took away my choices, but I kept going back to the same politicians.
The diagnosis? Battered voter syndrome.
I fell for the same old lies. They were just playing with my emotions, telling me what I wanted to hear. That's not right.
Stop the insanity of voting for the same old abusers. Declare your independence from the two-party system and join the New Hampshire Liberty Party today. At nhliberty.info.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Friday, gold is $1 higher at $1,155 per ounce. Silver is up 14 cents at $15.89 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $244. We are seeing the first signs of a return of silver supply to the market, We have silver rounds and eagles back in stock. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
You can join us here on Free Talk Live. It's the live Sunday edition of the program. And with you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
And Mark.
And our website, freetalklive.com, should be undergoing some maintenance tonight. So not during the show. It's online right now. But after our show is over, live Eastern Time, 10 p.m.,
expect some problems.
The site may become inaccessible for a short period of time or perhaps all night. You never know how long these internet rollout things are going to take. But we're looking to upgrade the website. And I'm excited about the new version. Mark, you've seen the teaser on the new version.
Looks great.
So we'll tell you more about that once it's done, but expect that to be happening later tonight at freetalklive.com. Now, you got a business you're starting up, you're going to need to have business cards. And business cards, most places, are still pretty expensive. VistaPrint?
You can pay $200. Pretty
not
easy.
Expensive at VistaPrint. You can pay $9.99 for 500 business cards. That's what you can get when you use code FTL at VistaPrint.com. 500 business cards starting at just $9.99. That's up to 50% savings over regular site pricing. It's a fantastic deal. Their quality is great, and they're easy to customize, and you can't beat the price. So try their 500 business cards for just $9.99 using code FTL. It's super easy to use their online tool. I've done it more than once, and I made a custom card where I already had the graphics prepared. Most people don't have that. I made some Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree palm cards that I can hand out to people.
Yeah.
But most people don't have that, so you're probably going to need to do your own from scratch in a lot of cases. You can customize the text, the colors, the backsides. You can even upload your logo to one of their existing designs, or if you've got what I have, which is pre-done graphics, you can use those too. So whatever level of effort you want to put into this, you can do with VistaPrint's tools. Go to VistaPrint.com if you want to upgrade the card. Of course, you can do that. Thicker stock, brilliant finishes like metallic, spot gloss, and raised print. I got to say, that metallic sounds really cool. I've certainly seen that effect on, like, the trading cards, you know?
As long as it gets people's attention and they're not throwing away the card, then it's working.
VistaPrint. Go and use code FTL and get those 500 business cards starting at just $9.99. As we continue here, you're certainly still welcome to discuss the offensive Halloween displays, especially if you're somebody who thinks that they should be somehow prohibited or restricted. If you think it's un-American to have an offensive Halloween display, I say that it's totally American to do something like that, given that the idea of freedom of speech is a relatively sort of American concept, I suppose. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Bad news for those of you in New Jersey and New York. You probably already knew how offensive the tolls were that
it's
you have to
really
pay.
It's not really news. I mean, it's just a quantifying of what's so, right? I mean, it's...
The news is that the top three tolling agencies in the country are all in the New York, New Jersey region, together accounting for nearly a third of all the tolls collected nationwide. This according to an industry group that has run the numbers. This story coming from NJ.com, as in New Jersey, NJ.com. The top three include the New Jersey Turnpike Authority at number one with $1.42 billion in tolls collected on the Turnpike and the Garden State Parkway back in 2013. $1.42 billion in just 1 year's time for just two roads.
You know,
you can't get off of the Turnpike, basically. There's like no other way to go through New Jersey, basically. So they run everybody through this gauntlet, and you have to pony up if you want to go that direction.
Yeah, it's, a lot of people discredit libertarians because we want toll roads, they say. We want, obviously, what makes sense is that people pay for whatever the value is for traveling from one place to another, or that value is, given in some manner or another. But people hate toll roads.
Yeah, I don't think that, I don't want to have toll roads. My idea would be to just allow the market to decide how to fund roads, and that could be all manner of different things. Roads could be sponsored, billboards. There are all manner of different ways to pay for it. Neighborhood associations, business associations could sponsor it.
If a neighborhood association sponsors it, it's going to be passed on in some fashion or another to the neighborhood, right? So the people that are there.
Sure, sure. So but the person who's taxes. Driving through won't necessarily have to pay a toll.
Yeah, I'm...
If you come to visit your friends, you don't want to have to pay a toll to get into the neighborhood.
I think that neighborhoods are going to have to pay for their own roads. It doesn't seem like
people... A lot of them do already.
It doesn't seem likely that they would have tolls, but some of them might. Some of them might want tolls just to keep people out.
There are
islands in Florida where it costs a great deal of money to get onto the island because they paid for the bridge and they wanted to pay for the bridge so that they could keep people off. $3 or $5 will keep down the tourists. They're going to go to a different beach. So that's one idea. Another is that I often think is that major thoroughfares will probably be sponsored by businesses that you can go to on those major thoroughfares. You need to get from one point to another, that maybe Walmart will pitch in for a portion of that road.
And then, Michelin Tire, this road brought to you by Toyota.
Yeah.
Whatever.
The Toyota dealer, wherever you have to go. Because in radio, one of the reasons that people buy radio ads is because people are out there. Right? How many ads are there that you hear that ask you if you're hungry? And, mm-hmm. Thinking about a sandwich right now, those kind of ads.
Right. Pull off the road, go to Subway or right? whatever.
they're telling you that for a reason, because they know you're in a car in all likelihood.
Listening to the radio, odds are good. Yeah.
And that's the same way with the advertising on billboards. And if there's billboards, then there's demand for advertising while you're going down the road. Maybe you don't want to see the road itself, painted blue with the white Walmart symbol.
Great.
Going down.
Outbid them.
Right. Outbid them and then have that section of road brought to you by somebody who just like black and
boring
yellow roads.
The Boring Roads Corporation.
Whatever. So what? So what they want to pay? I'll drive on whatever they want me to drive on as long as I can do it for free.
Thing with these toll roads is a lot of them are proposed as temporary. Like, oh yeah, we just need to raise the money to pay for the road. But they always stay. I mean, when have they ever removed tolls from roads? I know it's happened in New Hampshire a couple times.
It has to have happened somewhere sometime.
Yeah. The top three. All right, so New Jersey Turnpike number one with $1.42 billion in tolls on the Garden State Parkway and Turnpike in 2013. Number two, Port Authority of New York and New Jersey, which took in $1.33 billion at its four bridges and two tunnels linking the two states. I think it was that one that hit us for $19 when we were crossing through New York City in a 26-foot truck.
That
$19.
Just almost 10 years ago.
And that was 10 years ago, yeah. So it's probably like $25 or something like that now. And finally, the third on the list, the Metropolitan Transportation Authority, which collected $1.23 billion at its New York City bridges and tunnels. So you add all that up, you got more than $4 billion in tolls for those three agencies in total. And according to the International Bridges, Tunnels, and Turnpike Association...
There's an association for them?
That's right. It was nearly a third, so almost one-third of the $13 billion collected from motorists nationwide. So of all the other 48 states... They only account for two-thirds.
I guess what I want to know is why I shouldn't be laughing at these folks and their ridiculous costs that they have to pay.
It's a real sad thing. I feel terrible for those people living in New York, and especially for all the truckers and the professional drivers that have to drive through there in order to do business in other places.
The drivers basically, when a trucker has to pay, it's going into the cost of the things that they're trucking.
That's true.
So every one of us is paying for it.
That's a good point. Yeah, we're all paying these tolls, even if we don't live in New York City. So
another thing about New York, one of the amazing things about it is that you can't go to New England without passing through it if you're driving. If you want to avoid these tolls, as I do, we add another 100 miles onto our trip just to avoid the tolls and the traffic that come with New York City, going through Jersey and Washington, D.C. My wife and I drive down once a year to see the family down in Florida. And, it's another 100 miles. Now, we drive a Prius, so that 100 miles isn't so bad in cost.
You want to round out the last of the top 10 list here. Illinois is at number 4, Pennsylvania's Turnpike Commission at 5, Florida's Turnpike Enterprise, they call it there, at 6. Bay Area, that's California's Toll Authority at 7, New York State Thruway Authority after that at number 8. 855-450-FREE is our number. Free Talk Live.
Ever wish you had a business that ran itself, put money in your pocket, and you didn't have to go to work? If I could turn your current life into that business, then list it in the right systems that put money in your pocket, so potentially you didn't have to go to work. Is that something you might be interested in? Credit Success Secrets Revealed is exactly that. We help you document your life as a business. We place that data in the right systems to trigger automatic personal and business credit that works. We teach you how to get business funding to buy assets that put money in your pocket. Credit Success Secrets Revealed works 100% of the time, no matter your situation. It's as easy as following simple directions. We practically fill it out for you. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people get cash in their hands right now. Call 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or go to creditsuccesssecretsrevealed.com.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at patriotnecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
Patriotnecklace.com?
Patriotnecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from patriotnecklace.com.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey System. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallow Keen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. If you have a business, you know that IT can be frustrating, but it doesn't have to be. IT can serve your needs reliably, predictably, and on time. Rootwork Infotech helps businesses achieve always-on reliability. Their nerds know business and can meet your needs. To prove it, they'll give you 30 minutes on the phone with a senior consultant for free to answer any of your IT questions. Just go to rootwork.it/FTL to get your free call. That's rootwork.it/FTL.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, the live Sunday edition where you, just like any night of the show, can bring up whatever's on your mind. Now, we've talked about offensive Halloween displays. Maybe you want to comment on those. Perhaps there's one in your town that is stirring up controversy. Maybe you're the operator of it. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Plus, the news is that drivers in New Jersey and New York, the three different associations of government that are charging people various tolls in places, are in total nearly one third of all of the tolls collected in the United States. So they're right there. All of them are happening basically, or the plurality of them are happening in the New Jersey and New York areas. Let's see. So on the rest of this list here, North Texas Tollway Authority at number 9 and Harris County, Texas Toll Authority at number 10. The number 10 is $560 million. The top toll taker, according to the article, was New Jersey, $1.42 billion in 1 year for just two
roads.
They do
really seem to run you through that New Jersey Parkway.
They sure do. And of course, you know, it's one of those things where you get off, you got to pay the toll, so you want to stay on. And that means that if you want
to
get gas, well, also you got to pay more in gas and food too, because they have those state-run stores that are sort of, contracted out to sort of this state-approved monopoly provider, essentially.
And they're not exactly the cheapest places to eat.
No, you'll pay double for a McDonald's hamburger, or seemingly close to that.
Like going to the movies, you're going to pay more.
So if you want to comment, tolls, whatever's on your mind tonight here, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Carl is on the line in New Jersey, listening to WPG. Hey, Carl.
Yeah, you know, I want to talk about, you know, we have a pretty low gas tax, but we're number two in taxes. I think New York State's number one. People and businesses are leaving our state because it's too highly taxed. Yet, after the November election, we've been hearing the rumbling, the Democrats, because they control the state, they want to raise the gas tax. And my senator says, we can't fix your road with smoke and mirrors, right, or the bridges. And I say, look to the other states and see what they're doing right. In other words, we're one of the highest states for cost of repairing the roads and bridges. And I say, yep. So,
you think that's unions?
It could be, but
I don't
then
know.
It's unions and old boy contracts, right? Which are mixed together to some extent. I mean, some construction contractor is getting the golden deal out of New York State and is charging more than they have to, and of course they're paying union rates, so that means they're paying more than they have to get things done.
Right.
Sometimes union means you're going to get a better job. I mean, I don't know.
And then.
Go ahead.
And then they're donating money to the elected officials. It's just a big circle, right?
It sure is, and you're not in it.
No, we're just paying Thank you.
Thanks for the call. I appreciate it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Yep. That's 855-450-3733. How do you turn that around? Right now, according to the story at NJ.com, the New York, New Jersey region's bridges and tunnels are among the highest priced individual toll crossings in the country. $16 to cross the MTA's Verrazano Bridge, $14 for all Port Authority crossings when paying in cash. Port Authority tolls will go up this year in December, according to the fifth and final increment of what is a record hike that was approved back in 2011. So, I mean, wow, that's for a standard car, $16 to go through, because it's more for an 18-wheeler.
Yep, government's a big, well-paid club, and you're not in it.
It's true. Jason is on the line with us here, listening in North Dakota to KTGO. Hey, Jason.
Hi. Hey. Surprised I actually got through today.
But, it's super easy. You shouldn't be surprised.
Well, there you go. I guess I should call you guys more often.
You should. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Okay. Well, when the whole mess hit the fan about Volkswagen cheating on their nitrous oxide emissions, I kind of celebrated a little bit, and I have to give you a little backstory on that. I don't always agree with you guys on everything, but I agree with you completely that we are being backed into a corner by all these regulatory agencies, and basically people just go along because they're afraid.
Sure.
And the nitrogen oxides, a lot of people don't know what that is, and it sounds really scary to a lot of people.
It's Isn't it not in corn? Toxic. The corn emits it when it grows?
Yes, it does. Funny that you should say that. It actually occurs naturally. In fact, I joked that somebody should, we better make sure that Bernie Sanders doesn't add controlling the nitric oxide emissions from forest fires to his regulatory agenda. Because there's people who would, give him a bump in the polls for that.
Yeah, but we outlaw forest fires.
That's right. And I happen to believe that most forest fires happen because the forests, because it's illegal to go pick the deadwood out of the forest, so it just piles up and becomes a tinderbox. Government is usually the problem, and in this case, government basically has, I've been saying for years, started setting emission standards. Basically because the environmental left wants to take diesel vehicles off the road. I believe that's the goal. And so basically the automakers have been put in a position where they had no choice but to either cripple the system, their systems horrendously,
right,
or put on the urea injection systems, which basically make them useless in the winter in a cold climate because the stuff's two-thirds water and it will freeze, and it will destroy expensive sensors when it does, and you'll get like 20 horsepower out of it without it. I mean, it's an absolute disaster. Or you could do what Volkswagen, and now it's come out that Audi and Mercedes and Mazda and somebody else have been doing the exact same thing with pretty much the exact same software, which is basically do what standardized testing has done in schools. You teach to the test.
Right.
So basically they program the cars to pass the test, not really necessarily to have any particular result in the real world, but to pass the test.
Right.
And I look at that as absolutely brilliant. When Volkswagen first came out, I was like, yeah, I hope everybody does this.
So wait, how'd they get caught?
I'm not exactly sure how they got caught. My guess is that somebody actually did a road test as part of some state emissions testing program, and they're like, wait, this doesn't beat any of this. And so then somebody's like, well, let's look into this a little further because your brand new car should pass.
I heard that it was sort of a well-known secret amongst mechanics and these sorts of things. People that would know. There are people that tinker around with the computers in cars in order to make them better, and perhaps they would know in that circumstance.
So what is happening to them? Are they being targeted by the government now for some kind of punishment? Is there like a forced recall or what's going on?
There actually has been a forced recall of a number of Volkswagen models, but now basically what's happening is, and I'm, like I said, I'm celebrating, we're finding out that there has been a great deal of civil disobedience against these ridiculous and unmerited standards for nitrous oxide emissions. In fact, even I'm reminded of something I saw. I used to watch British Top Gear quite a bit, and there was a supercar that was made by a European manufacturer, and they wanted to sell it over here. And for years and years and years, they couldn't do it because our nitrous oxide emission standards were so, his word was daft, which is the British word for stupid or crazy. And
now, a lot of the environmental types bought the Volkswagens because they felt like they were doing a good thing, getting the diesel. I went and looked, and I was interested in the gas mileage that one might get out of it, as opposed to the environmental issues. But some people bought them for that reason. Those people probably rightly feel a little grumpy, you know.
I would agree, and the sad thing is. Diesel has the capability to give you near hybrid fuel economy with none of the heavy metals, none of the rare earths, none of the risks of fires from electrical problems, and none of the batteries to wear out and replace. Diesel really is, in many ways, everything the environmental left wants, except they're just absolutely terrified of diesel emissions.
Yep. And particulate matter, so right?
Particulate matter and nitrogen oxide.
Jason, really informative call. Thank you for making it tonight. I appreciate it. That was the first time that I'd seen the headline, but I really hadn't taken a look at that story. 855-450-FREE is our number.
I really wonder whether those cars that are tested like that are going to be better or worse after they get the fix.
855-450-3733. You can take control of the airwaves here. This is Free Talk Live's Live Sunday Show.
As a pioneer of the e-commerce movement, Overstock.com is proud to be the first major retailer to accept Bitcoin. Overstock was the first because Patrick Byrne, Overstock's CEO and founder, firmly believes in personal freedom and cryptocurrency. Over the past 16 years, Overstock has furnished over 18 million homes with a diverse line of products to suit everyone's unique styles and preferences. Support Overstock and freedom of choice while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more.
When the most powerful and destructive witch in 13th century France chooses a successor, her frightened young protege, Liana, escapes into the wild. Pursued by witch hunters, the town watch, and her mistress, Liana's only hope is a pair of newly returned crusaders, one with PTSD, the other a complete rascal. The Witch's Hand by Wendy Joseph is a cut above the usual sword and sorcery fare. Available now at your favorite booksellers or visit WendyJosephWrites.com.
There comes a time when you need custom embroidered or screen printed apparel for your business, organization, or a special event. Corporate Casuals has been helping people create great looking logoed apparel for over 25 years. They can produce a single piece or thousands using name brand apparel like Nike, Patagonia, Adidas, and Hanes. Create your logo in their online embroidery design studio or upload your existing logo and they'll turn it into embroidery. Go to corporatecasuals.com/FTL and include FTL in the order notes and save 5% on your order.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, October 11th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.85 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,156 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $249. Antiwar.com reports Israeli troops were out in force in the occupied West Bank and along the Gaza border fence, attacking Palestinian protesters as the unrest in the territory continues to grow. Over the course of Friday, 7 Palestinians were killed and 470 others were wounded nationwide, many of them critically. On Saturday morning, Israeli troops killed another 5 people, including 2 children in Gaza. Israel has been cracking down on unrest in the area around Jerusalem and the West Bank all week, following a terrorist attack with new restrictions on Arabs across the area and then moving militarily against protesters rallying against those restrictions. The West Bank was again the site of most of the casualties, with 1 killed in Hebron and 410 others wounded. The deaths overwhelmingly came from the Gaza Strip, which was previously not part of the latest military operations. On Saturday, however, reports of demonstrations along the border fence had the military reacting aggressively, opening fire on the demonstrators with live rounds, killing 6 and wounding 60. Many of the 60 wounded in Gaza were not expected to survive, as health officials say they were shot in the head and neck with sniper fire and gravely wounded. Among West Bank injuries, many of them were not likely to be fatal, with a lot of protesters shot with rubber bullets and 279 of the hospitalized recovering from exposure to tear gas. There were few reports of Israeli troops being wounded, but despite this, officials presented the various incidents as clashes. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports the Pentagon has temporarily barred the for-profit University of Phoenix from recruiting on military bases and using veteran tuition assistance amid an ongoing investigation into possible policy violations. The school, the nation's largest private university, is not allowed to enroll new military students under the Defense Department's Education Assistance Program. The Department of Defense indicated the violations include misusing trademarked United States military insignia and failing to get proper authorization when recruiting on military bases. A Pentagon spokesman cited reports of non-compliance by the school but would not provide more information. The Federal Trade Commission and California's Attorney General are also reviewing the school's recruiting practices. The Department of Justice and Department of Education are reportedly coordinating ongoing investigations. The University of Phoenix has more than 200,000 enrolled students, both civilian and military, in 29 locations in 17 states. A majority of the students attend classes online. The school has also come under fire as one of several for-profit universities being blamed for driving up outstanding student loan debt and college tuition cost.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports the U.S. Department of Defense will seek to make condolence payments to families of victims of a U.S. airstrike that hit a Doctors Without Borders hospital in Kunduz, Afghanistan, killing 22 people. Pentagon spokesman Peter Cook said in a statement, "The Department of Defense believes it is important to address the consequences of the tragic incident at the Doctors Without Borders hospital in Kunduz, Afghanistan," adding the United States would also pay to repair the charity hospital. The medical charity is pressing for an international commission to investigate the possible war crime. Among those killed were 12 Doctors Without Borders staff. On Tuesday, Defense Secretary Ash Carter said the U.S. military deeply regretted the loss of life and was acknowledging its mistake and working to understand what went wrong. Carter said in a statement, "The U.S. military takes the greatest care in our operation to prevent the loss of innocent life, and when we make mistakes, we own up to them. That's exactly what we're doing right now." This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Turning to Capitol Hill, House Republicans are considering their own version of the Violence Against Women Act. The GOP hopes their new No Punch, Pretty Lady bill will finally help the party appeal to female voters.
No punch, no rape. Pass law. Women give big smiles at us again. Big votes.
Among its statutes, the bill would introduce harsher penalties for putting fists to women's face and proposes that if ladies smell nice like flowers, no smash lady.
And what if pretty lady Al-Qaeda? What if she death panel? What if she Benghazi? Yes, in some cases, punch lady.
In addition to increasing funding to shelters for crying ladies hurt from doing sex with bad guys, the bill also includes a clause complimenting the nation's women for losing weight.
And in other headlines, Lady Gaga kidnaps Commissioner Gordon. A man who likes to move it, move it is still searching for the perfect song. And Rod Stewart is mistaken for an elderly aunt.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live, and you can join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREEZE. Our number, 855-450-3733. With you tonight, you've got Ian.
And Mark.
It's the live Sunday edition of the program, and of course, you can bring up anything that is the point of Free Talk Live. One presidential candidate wants to end the war on drugs and pardon Edward Snowden, according to countercurrentnews.com. Who is he? Who is it, Mark? Who's that one candidate?
I would assume, I don't know. Go ahead.
John McAfee.
I gotcha.
John McAfee.
I was thinking Sanders.
I don't think he wants to pardon Snowden, does he?
I don't know. It was the best I could do.
I think Sanders may actually be better on Snowden than, at least verbally, than Rand Paul, but certainly, but Sanders doesn't want to end the war on drugs.
Rand Paul said that he wanted to see Snowden share a cell with, and I can't
Bradley
remember.
Bradley Manning, I think.
No, it was with whoever allowed the leaks or kept the secrets or perpetrated the spying or whatever it was. I'd have to go look. But what he says is, essentially in saying this is that Snowden did something illegal, and I wouldn't doubt that he did. In order to show us something that was illegal.
Yeah.
And that's important.
That makes him a hero.
I agree that he's a hero, and I think that he's a whistleblower, and so therefore should not have the punishment. But at the very least, Rand Paul is showing that the thing that was being done in the first place was a tremendous disservice to the American public.
You mean going after him?
No.
Or the lies by the NSA?
The spying, the lies about the spying, you know, the whole thing.
Unfortunately, Rand does want to put him in a jail cell, which is not cool.
Well,
so the story here...
It's an adroit step aside, but go ahead. He's certainly not offering a pardon.
Yeah. John McAfee likely rings a bell for most simply by virtue of his cybersecurity noteworthy surname, which makes his September announcement of his bid for president as a member of the Cyber Party quite logical. As Americans' faith in, well, just about everything surrounding traditional elections wanes to perilously close to an all-time nadir, McAfee's platform shows surprising glints of common sense worth more than a simple passing glance. A nadir is a bottom point, a lower point, by the way.
Is it pronounced nadir? I thought it was nader.
But you'll have to look that one
wrong.
Up. McAfee's reasons for running, as well as his stance on a number of pertinent issues currently asked of major party candidates, were clarified in an interview with S.M. Gibson on a recent edition of Anti-Media Radio. That's kind of an interesting name for a radio show. Quite frankly, McAfee opens with his reason for jumping into the field of presidential hopefuls, quote, "I would much rather go fishing than run for president, but my advisors and my friends, particularly my fans, finally threatened to break my kneecaps if I didn't do it. Here's the issue," he says. "They've been urging me to run for about a year, and I finally looked at the field of candidates and realized that we don't have anybody running who's qualified to fix the problems of this country. I mean, we live under an insane government.
Things are going to be awesome under Trump. He said so."
"This is the absolute truth," says McAfee. "If you look at the simplest things like the TSA, the Transportation Security Administration, they tell us that they're here to protect us. Yet when I'm standing in line with my belt and shoes off and they're scrutinizing my belongings and my hands are in the air while they're frisking me, I don't feel protected. I feel like the enemy." And sometimes when
I feel just annoyed, I feel like it's a big, giant government make-work program that's found nothing, spends its time stealing water bottles from people. And, there's productive people doing TSA stuff that could be doing something else. It's just a big, fat waste of time.
Daryl Perry is letting me know that he is another candidate who supports pardoning Edward Snowden, yes. And he is running for the Libertarian Party nomination.
Well, he can't be a Libertarian Party candidate until he gets the nomination, right?
He's still planning to run for it. I don't know if he's going to withdraw if another candidate gets the nod from the Libertarian Party. I guess we'll have to find out from him on that. So anyway, McAfee says that we're living under an insane government and he doesn't feel protected. He feels like the enemy. He says sometimes when you feel like the enemy, maybe to the government, you are the enemy. He says they tell us they're doing this to assure us that we're not the enemy that they're trying to protect us from. Moving on to the state's inability to balance its checkbook, McAfee hit on the absurdity of fiat currency. He said about that, fiat currency is money that you can just sort of print from
thin air. No, just the government just prints it. It has to be given...
Oh, only government can do fiat?
Well, it would have to be a powerful organization because the term fiat means that it is, you're basically ordered to accept it. It's a fiat. A fiat is a dictate handed out by a sovereign.
Got it. So regarding money, he says, we live in a country that's illiterate in cybersecurity, yet we're in an age when the next war will be a cyber war. We are dysfunctional. Our government is $19 trillion in debt. It doesn't have any money. When you're in debt with zero money, a friend says, loan me $20. You can't do it. Another country comes to the U.S. government and says, we need money. Can you help us? The U.S. government prints money out of nothing. The government is living a fantasy. It's a dream. Mm. It's a dysfunctional government from every standpoint. It's paranoid, afraid of its own citizens, incompetent, and it's living in a fantasy world. This has to change. And I don't see anyone in the lineup of candidates that has the understanding, the qualifications, or the nerve to make the changes necessary. Unquote.
Well, he doesn't know who Daryl Perry is, but yes, at this point, in fact, there aren't very many.
Daryl says that the Libertarian Convention is coming up in May. There are currently 5 people recognized by the Libertarian Party as seeking the presidential nomination. And he says, if I don't find the LP's candidate who they ultimately choose to be sufficiently Libertarian, he will continue his campaign as an independent Libertarian through to the election. So there's your pledge from Daryl, who is our Thursday night co-host, and you can find his site at fppradio.com. He does his own radio show and is running for president for the Libertarian Party. McAfee discovered, as many of us have, that the two-party system, the paradigm itself, is purely a hollow, artificial construct. About that, he says, quote, here's the thing with the two-party system. The parties are machines with over 100 years of stagnation. If you become a representative of the party, you simply become a part of the machine. You become a cog in that big wheel. The machine has no heart, has no soul.
And it will grind you up and spit you out if you try to run against it.
It's a mechanical gadget designed to self-perpetrate. We need to get back to a government with heart. I don't know if we ever had that. Our government was founded
on... It's a nice thing to say, though. People like to get back. They don't really seem to want to move forward very much.
Our government was founded on the principle that government is a service to the people. Now it's become a seat of power. People want to become...
The government is a service organization. I don't know whether it was founded to be a service to our people, but it is. The government was found is a service organization. It's supposed to serve you, at the very least, with protection from foreign invaders or something like that. Some people would want to be served in other ways. That's kind of where the argument comes in.
Well, I disagree. You can only provide a valid service in my book if it's provided on a consensual basis. So government's an organization of force. It's a monopoly on the use of force, and they will provide their services to you whether you like them or not, whether you consent to them or not, or whether you support them or not.
That's true in the sense of the monopoly, but I mean they are
because I want to opt out. I don't want their services.
Yeah, but you probably want a lot of the services that they provide.
Not the federal government, not a single one of them. Local government, okay, I'll take water, I'll take some fire protection, I'll take some roads cleared, sure. I'm fine with paying for some of those basic services, but federal government doesn't they fund some of it, but that's just because they've stolen our money in the first place. They don't provide anything of value to me.
What about the interstate?
Anybody can build a road. The states and the local governments can handle roads. They handled them before the federal government handled them, and if the federal government disappeared tomorrow, we'd still have roads. Does anybody disagree with that? The toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE.
855-450-3733. McAfee says people want to become congressmen and senators and the president because they're seats of power. They hunger for power, unquote.
Yeah, I'd say that's accurate.
Yeah, I like a lot of what he's saying. He actually described himself as an anarchist in an interview with Jeff Berwick on his Anarchast podcast. We played some clips of that when we first heard the announcement that McAfee was going to be running for president. I did actually since then reach out to him and did get a response back.
You did?
But since then, the ball's been dropped, I think, by those folks. But I'm sure they're getting a lot of media requests. Our toll-free number, if you want to join us here on this live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live, is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. It's Free Talk Live.
Ever wish you had a business that ran itself, put money in your pocket, and you didn't have to go to work? If I could turn your current life into that business, then list it in the right systems that put money in your pocket, so potentially you didn't have to go to work. Is that something you might be interested in? Credit Success Secrets Revealed is exactly that. We help you document your life as a business. We place that data in the right systems to trigger automatic personal and business credit that works. We teach you how to get business funding to buy assets that put money in your pocket. Credit Success Secrets Revealed works 100% of the time, no matter your situation. It's as easy as following simple directions. We practically fill it out for you. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people get cash in their hands right now. Call 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or go to CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com.
This is a healthcare alert from the Pain Relief Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee, back, shoulder, or ankle pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You don't have to suffer any longer. You can immediately qualify for a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost to you by calling our 24/7 Pain Relief Hotline at 866-389-0620. Delivery is free and all paperwork is handled for you. If you are on Medicare and have knee, back, shoulder, or ankle pain, don't wait. You can qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost by calling our 24/7 pain hotline now at 866-389-0620. Our representatives are standing by 24/7 to take your call and rush you your pain-relieving brace at little or no cost to you. Shipping is free and all paperwork is handled for you. Just call 866-389-0620. That's 866-389-0620. Again, 866-389-0620.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
BlakeDevelopment.net is a global leader in website creation, app development, and online marketing, catering to businesses of all sizes. There's really no job too big or too small for BlakeDevelopment.net. Do you have an idea for a killer app, but you don't know how to code it? Are you missing out on online sales? Or maybe your business needs help with social media. Websites start at just $200, and they're offering 3 years of free domain registry. Yes, they take Bitcoin. 844-SITE-123. BlakeDevelopment.net, 844-SITE-123.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us on the radio. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. If you've been wanting to buy yourself a Free Talk Live t-shirt, you can do that. They are now available again online. And I guess, again, I shouldn't say that. They're new. They're a new design, the one I'm wearing right now.
But you can get t-shirts, Free Talk Live t-shirts again, and it's been
a decade, I think,
like a decade
since we've had the shirts available. There have been other shirts in existence, but they're new, and actually, thank you to, oh gosh, was it Chris who created these?
Well, listeners. He had help. Corporate Casuals is his company, and they put it together.
Right, that's what I'm saying. It's his company.
Well, and he doesn't own it. He works for it.
Gotcha. Well, anyway, one of our listeners facilitated this deal. And that's cool.
Corporate Casuals is big, right? Like they really do this stuff. They're also going to put together, maybe some embroidery stuff for us.
Wow, it's fancy. Yeah. So you can pre-order one of these Free Talk Live shirts. There are a couple different designs. There's the one that I'm wearing right now, which says "Taxes are theft" on the front, and then our Free Talk Live logo on the back. And then there's just the plain old Free Talk Live logo shirt. You can go and place your order for pre-order before October 31st. You'll be part of the initial run of these shirts. There are ladies' cut shirts, by the way. So,
yes.
You know, ladies, there we did think of you in this. Gear.freetalklive.com is where you can go. That's gear.freetalklive.com.
I love the logo with the ringer tee that we got. So a ringer tee is when
that's what I'm wearing right now.
People aren't necessarily at cam.freetalklive.com.
I know, you're going to describe it. Thank you.
Yeah, it's when the sort of sleeve on a short sleeve, you know, just that little bit on the end of the sleeve is a different color, and the collar is a different color.
So it almost looks like you're wearing a shirt over top of a different color shirt.
Yeah, kinda. I guess it would be kind of showing in there.
And then contrast. We've got gold is the edge, the trim, if you will, and then black is the color of the shirt.
Free Talk Live's colors are yellow and black, and they happen to have corresponded to the colors of the voluntarist flag, too, which is kind of funny considering we're basically voluntarists.
I don't know if that was coincidence, Mark. It was probably intentional. But yes,
what do you mean?
Go to gear.freetalklive.com, meaning that our artist probably chose those colors intentionally.
I didn't think that was the case at all.
Okay. Well, it was Johnson, our co-host, who did the design.
12 so years ago.
Those were still the those colors back then.
We hadn't even heard the term.
I don't know about that.
I remember having logos back then, and I remember the day that you handed me this pamphlet that said something like "Anarchy is the answer." And I'm like, "Oh no, dude, you are not going to do this to me."
Really?
I don't even
remember that.
Yeah. You handed me some kind of pamphlet, and I'm like, "You can't. You cannot do this." And sure enough, you went full on libertarian at that point.
Well, I'm not an anarchist.
Yes, but I recall it had an anarchy symbol at the top.
Okay.
There's plenty of anarchist thought within the libertarian sphere, mm-hmm. whether we like that term or not.
I think it's
a grammatically incorrect term that is unnecessarily bombastic.
And I agree.
When you look it up online, like, just Google it. Just go and Google the term anarchy. You'll find a philosophy that looks nothing like libertarianism. However, mm-hmm. there is, just like all schools of thought have influences from other areas, you know, libertarianism has a great deal of thought that's influenced by anarchist thinkers from the past. Academics, they don't care about this terminology the way that people like you and I, who are, we're the face, we're bringing this message to people. People that use terms like anarchist to describe somebody who wants to bring, competition to the area of governance, if they're talking to other academics, fine. If they're just speaking to some friends around a table, they use the term anarchist in order to describe themselves, to catch some attention so that they can then explain the ideas of liberty for a long time to their friends, fine. But you certainly couldn't go on the radio and say, "Hey, we're some anarchists," and then proceed to describe something that is different than the philosophy of anarchy.
So John McAfee running for president, the security guy, that John McAfee, the software that many of you probably have installed on your computers, that guy,
He's running for president, and he described himself as an anarchist, which, again, I agree with you, Mark, that it is a bombastic kind of phrase that can offend people.
It's not even accurate.
Yeah.
I mean, if it was accurate, the definition, you know, when you Googled it, you would get the definition of it. Now, when you go to the Merriam-Webster's dictionary, you get a fine definition, mm-hmm. but most people don't do that.
Most people are going to Wikipedia or whatever. Right?
What most people are going to do is they're going to use the definition that they've been given, which is terrorist.
A bomb thrower.
Yeah.
Sure.
So that's like, you know, if you want to adopt a term because you feel that it's somehow logical or that it's honest, you need to consider that if you love children, that you should call yourself a pedophile, too.
That's not a good idea.
It's a bad idea, right? I mean, but if you parse out the term pedophile, you'll find child lover.
Yeah,
and, you know, you love children? Here you go. Right? Like, maybe you need to look at a different term. Plus, anarchist means a person who it means no rulers, right? I mean, that's another definition of it. No rulers. Well, if your body has no ruler, it's going to lie on the ground. It's a self. Your body is self-ruled. So you are better described as an autarchist.
Autarchist
depends on how you want to look at it. Now, when you go looking at this in Wikipedia, you will find the big anarchy that this is a, you know, under the umbrella of anarchist.
Autarchy is. I see.
And I would argue that you could just say that, frankly, every political system is under the umbrella of anarchy. Because what's the difference between what we have today and anarchy? One organization claims a monopoly privilege over ruling over you with no legitimacy whatsoever. You know.
Well, some people think it's legit. We don't, but there are plenty of people who think that the ruling of the United States government is legitimate.
Harriet Tubman said she'd freed 1,000 slaves and she'd have freed 1,000 more if only they had known that they weren't free.
It's true, and it still is true today. The slavery has simply changed forms. So when John McAfee, the software magnate, describes himself as an anarchist, obviously we can't be sure exactly what he means by that, but I suspect that he's more of our kind of anarchist than the left's kind of anarchist, let's say. Because there seems to be like the anarcho-socialist types or the anarcho-communists and then more of the anarcho-voluntarist or capitalist or whatever you want to call them, the people that don't want to form a new government after they take down the current one. So I don't know what his actual beliefs are when it comes to liberty, but he certainly sounds pretty darn good. There has been, this according to countercurrentnews.com, a major shift in government work where service of constituents once drove a person's position in Congress or even the highest office, lack of accountability has translated to corporate service and private interests. McAfee about this says, quote, "When's the last time you felt served by your government? You looked at your government and said, oh gosh, you've done such incredible things for me." He says he can't remember the last time.
So
that's a good question. When was the last time you felt served by the government? And let's use federal as a more specific example.
I like to use this example. So when, for instance, if I went out and bought a car, my wife says, "Mark, go buy a car for us today." And I go to the local Honda dealer and I buy an Accord, but I decide the salesman, for whatever reason, allows me to pay 6 to 10 times as much as I needed to pay for the car. Let's say
that's going to help his commission.
2 to 10 times as much as I needed to pay. Now, if you consider that, they'll probably let you do that, and that's what government programs cost. Would that be a victory?
My dad was 59 when he collapsed from a heart attack late last year. Just this past August was when we spread his ashes on the St. Croix River. I loved my dad, but boy was he stubborn. He hadn't been to the doctor in over 25 years. His excuse? He simply couldn't afford it. He wasn't a rich man by any means. At less than $107 per month, libertyoncall.org would have been the perfect alternative for my father. Don't wait. Go to libertyoncall.org right now for not just your sake, but for the sake of your loved ones. Again, that's libertyoncall.org.
KDArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period, with packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Why would you go anywhere else? KD offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KDArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free water purification kit for a limited time with any body armor package. Go to KDArmor.com. That's CATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
because we are smothering in spam, please do not reply to all when you can instead reply. I was recently among over 100 invited to a corporate reunion. It's always a warm affair, and that's the problem. Enthusiasm for our upcoming get-together caused many recipients to RSVP the organizer with a cheery reply to all. I can't wait. Then others piled on with a reply to all to that. Then the I'm out of my office now autoresponders joined in. So I replied to all, asking that we all reply only to the organizer. Hey, at least I tried. One invitee, apparently retired, shot back, point taken, but I really like seeing the responses since they're so positive. Smiley face. This better be an open bar. From SurvivalSpeech.com, I'm Holland Cook.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Friday, gold is $1 higher at $1,155 per ounce. Silver is up 14 cents at $15.89 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $244. We are seeing the first signs of a return of silver supply to the market. We have silver rounds and eagles back in stock. Give us a call at 800-874-9760. Or visit us online at rrbi.co.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live.
You're privileged to drive the road. You must follow the law.
No, I don't have to.
You're gonna double park and you're gonna make a left-hand turn in front of a cop?
Can I respond to you here, Barbara?
Go right ahead.
I'm not going to run a red light in front of a cop because he has a gun and is willing to hurt me, but I've run plenty
Wrong. He's not gonna hurt you. He's gonna give you a ticket.
Oh, but if I decide not to pull over, what will he do?
Well, that you're not obeying the law.
Barbara, I don't obey arbitrary words written down by strangers. Natural law, Barbara. That means if I do something, I expect consequences will come from that. Sometimes
right.
Good, sometimes bad.
You run a red
bad.
Light, somebody comes around, and you kill them.
I would never run a red light like that. When I run a red light, I stop first, look around, make sure no one is in danger, and then I go through.
You are such a phony.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm. You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, live Sunday edition continuing. We've got time for you. You can join us here toll free at 855-450-FREE. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
And Mark.
And coming up, Mark, you're going to be heading to Vegas in less than 3 weeks from now. The end of the month, October 29th and 30th. Why?
It's coming really soon. It's the Bitcoin Investor Conference, and it is at the beautiful D Hotel in downtown Las Vegas, as opposed to on the Strip. They're trying to, you know, sort of create another area, maybe connect the two, make the area, make Vegas even more awesome. And it is a lot of fun to go to Vegas, and you'll have a great time at the Bitcoin Investor Conference because they have got great speakers like Stephen Michaels, who's putting it on. Mm-hmm. I'm going to have a lot of great advice for Bitcoin investors. Trace Mayer, Paul Pui, Tone Vase, Joseph Von Perling, Bitcoin Bell, Stephanie Murphy, Brian Sovereign. Come out and see them, see me. We're going to be doing Free Talk Live for the first time ever live at the Bitcoin Investor Conference. You can just go to bitcoininvestor.com in order to get your tickets. They're very well priced. It's not going to be a big deal. Bitcoininvestor.com.
Very exciting. All right, so our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. We'll read a little bit more here from John McAfee, but he asked an important question, and that was, when was the last time you felt served by your government? I'll modify the question to, when was the last time you felt served by the federal government?
because
but even if it comes to the state and local governments,
well, you can argue. I can make some points for the local governments. You know, they'll respond to a police call.
Yep.
They will provide you with fire service.
Yep.
They will clear the roads.
Yep.
They will repair the roads, albeit not as fast.
Sometimes
as
they pick up the trash.
As
sometimes
we would like.
they provide you with water. Sometimes they do all kinds of things. But you need to consider what it costs. So if I was to go to the car dealer, as I was saying earlier, and I was to buy a brand new Honda Accord, which is a great automobile, and it will provide you with a lot of long, great service, or as will so many other automobiles out there. However, if I pay double to 10 times as much, which is what the estimates are the government programs cost, anywhere from double what you would have to pay to 10 times, there has to be some out there that are only 1.5. But even if I paid 50% more for the car than I needed to, and I came home and I said, honey, look, I bought a $20,000 car for $30,000. Aren't you excited? Laura would skin me alive.
You were still served, though.
But I was served, right? Like, I got a great product. Yeah. I just paid 1.5 too much.
Well, and with government, not only do you pay too much, but you usually don't get the greatest product either, right? Like, the road quality
but
is...
Yeah. Many people can't imagine anything better. They can't imagine roads that don't suck as bad as these. They can't imagine roads that aren't as full of cars as these are. Like, there's nothing... Because the government has been providing roads for so long... Even though it stole the right of way from the communities before that, or people that had them privately, or you know, bridges and things like that. Even though it stole all that, they've been doing it for so long, people just can't imagine anything. They're so uninventive that they'll say things like, "Well, you get rid of government. What about the roads?
Well, what about them? Go to Disney World. They got their own private roads.
Private
there.
Roads are all over this country. We can certainly provide private roads. The thing is that governments just provide them." At a higher cost. That is not good service.
So I still want to restrict my question, though, to federal government. What is the last time, when was the last time you felt served by the federal government, any of its agencies?
I have gone down the road on interstates and said to myself, man, these are so much better than U.S. roads. You know, I've just said that. Mm-hmm. I've also looked at aircraft carriers and fighter planes and said to myself, these things are awesome. And the federal government, to some extent or another, provides them. Obviously, private industry.
They pay private companies to make those.
They pay private companies to make them.
And that's not service. Them holding a piece of equipment isn't serving you.
And it comes down to what is it worth. There's the F-35 that's cost enough money to give every homeless person in America a mansion.
If they're using those things to drop bombs on people or shoot people, then I consider that the reverse of service. That's the last thing I want to see them doing.
I want whoever is claiming to protect me to drop bombs on and shoot certain people. But it's rare, and it's many times the bombs they've dropped and the people they've shot before that created the person that they needed to shoot in the future. You really can't keep on creating terrorists and then claim credit for killing the terrorists. You know
what
I mean?
Let's go to your calls, your thoughts. More from John McAfee here in a moment. We've got T on the line calling from Virginia. T, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Little off topic from what you've been talking about, but I wanted to see, I haven't been on the show in a while or listened to it, and I don't know if you guys have talked about it yet, but I wanted to see what you thought about the case in Irvine, Texas, where there were voluntary tribunals going on for Sharia law, and the state had to stop it because they're basically trying to get the first Sharia court with Sharia law for different laws against men and women in Texas, and then they said that the that they were hoping that would set a precedent that will be duplicated throughout the whole country, but Texas had to stop it.
I'm curious. I've never heard the story before. So you're saying that someone formed their own private court, so kind of an arbitrator, and they were
mosques. There were numerous mosques in the Texas area who were operating voluntary tribunals for Sharia law with their own people.
Well, what's wrong with that? I mean, if it's voluntary, then who cares?
Sometimes churches will require people to get married, to marry people that they will have, you know, these voluntary marriage counseling sessions that they have to sit in with on their preachers. So, I mean, that guy's sitting in there as a self-designated marriage counselor, and he'll provide rights like, you know, death and marriage and you know, baptism and these sorts of things. If a religious organization wishes to provide some kind of voluntary mediation, you know, whether I like it or not, really isn't consequential. If people who are participating in it are there voluntarily, then that's their business.
What if it is going against the Constitution, saying that we can't have separate laws for against American law, and saying like women can't no longer have the right to vote or even drive, or they have to have witnesses for, or at least 5 witnesses when they're raped? Like, what if those laws become on our land in Texas?
On your land in Texas? Well, how is a voluntary arbitration session that's going on in a mosque going to become the mandatory law of Texas?
It's not mandatory law, but those women would be treated that way on Texas land.
Okay, I get what you're saying. So those women are voluntarily in a community that they could otherwise leave if they wished, right? Like any one of these women could say to themselves, you know what? This is a bunch of bull crap. I'm going to go find me a white fella that's going to take good care of me and raise me and you know, treat me like a Christian would. And they could do that anytime, or just go and get a job and leave anytime they want. So they're voluntarily there. They're taking the good with the bad inside of a community, and or they like it. I don't know. I mean, you know, maybe they like being treated like that. I don't know, and I don't know the specifics of what's going on in that circumstance. But yes, this is still voluntary, and it's still none of your business or mine.
Well, the husbands are voluntary. Their wives are not.
Are they being held against their will?
I mean, their wives wouldn't have a choice if their husbands are committing to this form of law in Texas.
Sure, they have a choice. They can leave.
Yeah, I mean, ultimately, if I decide that I'm going to, let's say I want to join this community, and let's say this community is as you say it is, because I haven't read this story.
Yeah, we don't know. We're taking your word for it.
Take this word for it. We could even create an artificial one that doesn't have to have the word Muslim involved if we wanted to. But let's say I wanted to join one of these organizations, and I'm saying, honey, this is the way it's going to be. And she says, nope, no, it's not. And I go to work one day, and all the stuff's gone when I return.
Sounds like you got nothing. Thanks, T. 855-450-FREE. That's our toll-free number. That's 855-450-3733. The Sharia law
calls it false.
It probably is. A Sharia law, and let's talk about that more here in a moment. The Sharia law is a set of rules for Muslims, not for everyone else. It's Free Talk Live. 855-450-FREE.
When the most powerful and destructive witch in 13th century France chooses a successor, her frightened young protege, Liana, escapes into the wild. Pursued by witch hunters, the town watch, and her mistress, Liana's only hope is a pair of newly returned crusaders, one with PTSD, the other a complete rascal. The Witch's Hand by Wendy Joseph is a cut above the usual sword and sorcery fare, a thinking person's historical fantasy novel. Available now at your favorite booksellers or visit WendyJosephWrites.com. If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
The human body is more than 60% water. Your brain and muscles are 75% water. And your blood is 92% water. Water is vital to your body, and alkalizing your water is the key to keep it running at its best. AlkaVision Plasma pH drops keep your entire body healthy, boosts energy, promotes weight loss, and even fights cancer. Call 800-518-7615 or go to alkavision.com to find out more. That's alkavision.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid. We do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled freedom lovers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
It's Free Talk Live, live Sunday edition. We're here. We'll take your calls about what you want to discuss. And Sharia law, the scary Sharia law. It's Halloween, and Sharia law is going to take over the country, and the Muslims are going to force everyone under the scimitar. Well, maybe not. In fact, we actually will be talking to a Muslim about the last caller here in a moment, I believe. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. He brought up this Texas court story where there's apparently some kind of a voluntary association that is attempting to hold the Muslims in the area accountable by Sharia law, sort of an arbitration group, if you will. And we can talk more about that here. I also want to invite you to call in toll-free with your thoughts at 855-450-FREE. Also, Skype in at Skype username lrn.fm. That again, 855-450-3733. Ian and Mark in the studio. Dave is in New Jersey. You're on Free Talk Live. Dave, you're tuned to WPG. Go ahead.
Yeah, hi. About the Sharia law thing, I think you guys check into it, and you'll find out that, like, the women are abused, and if they leave, the husbands will come after them.
I have a friend who tried to leave the Amish community, and they surrounded him and tried to talk him back into it after he'd been gone a couple of weeks, back into the community and that sort of thing. What do you mean by the husbands will come after them?
Because the wife
will they use a gun to make them come back?
Yes.
Will they bodily
you
move them?
It.
Then that guy needs to be put in prison. We have laws for kidnapping in this country.
We have. You talk about Sharia law and like that. Check into it.
Well, we've checked into it. In fact, we actually have Will Coley on the line here from Muslims for Liberty. I'll bring him on here. Will, you know, you've been studying this for, close to a decade at this point?
About 11 years now I've been studying Islam specifically. I spent probably the last 6 years studying Islamic law and Islamic jurisprudence specifically, not just general Islamic history or Islamic studies, but focusing specifically in the Maliki School of Islamic legal jurisprudence for about 6 years now at the university level. I mean, I lecture on the topic at universities and colleges all over the U.S.
You've called before to talk about Sharia law. Your explanation, and correct me if I'm wrong, is that this is a set of rules for Muslims. It's not something that would apply to people who are not of the Islamic faith. And correct. So there's no real fear that this is going to be imposed upon everybody, because that's not the point of Sharia law. But beyond that, certainly, you know, the Quran came out in a time at a time when women were not at their best as far as being treated by men. There's no doubt about that. Although it's interesting, when you look at the history, the Quran and what it prescribes as far as how women are to be treated was actually progressive. It actually improved upon the situation for women, but it didn't. It certainly wasn't an equal situation. Is Sharia law? You know, does it allow what this caller Dave is saying? And he's still on the line, so you'll be responding directly to Dave. Dave is saying that it allows for women to be abused in a relationship and further to be kidnapped if they try to get away. Is that true? Do you know?
No. As a matter of fact, the Quran specifically states not to keep women who choose to leave as a way to abuse and get revenge on them for the fact that they want to leave. Now, there's a verse in the Quran that a lot of people try to use as like some type of an evidence for that men are above women. And basically what it states is that in relationships, men are a degree above women. But if you read the tafsir, the famous Mufassir Ibn Abbas, who was about 15 years old when the Prophet Muhammad died, he actually knew the Prophet Muhammad personally, stated that this degree that the Quran speaks of is that a man is required to fulfill all the rights of his wife, even if she is unable to fulfill all of his rights because of the difficulty in her position, as in dealing with the children, being pregnant, having to deal with a menstrual cycle.
When you say fulfill the rights, what does that mean, fulfilling her rights?
Women and men have rights over one another. Like my wife, the rights that I have for my wife is that she does not slander me publicly, that she protects my property in my absence, and she doesn't let anyone into my home in my absence. She doesn't let strange people into our home or onto our property in my absence. Her right over me is that I am to care for her in a kind and just manner. I am to feed her in a manner as good or better than I feed myself. I am to clothe her in a manner that's good or better than I clothe myself. I am to take care of all of her physical and emotional needs. I'm also required to take care of her sexual needs. If I am unable to help her climax, that's actually a grounds in an Islamic court for her to ask for a divorce from me.
So it sounds like Dave is super misinformed about this. Dave, where did you get your information from about the Sharia law?
I'm only going by what I was told by other people.
Ooh.
Who also studied things, and they're allowed, and I also learned
Now, when you say you studied something, so first of all, you were saying to us we should study this, but you yourself are only relying on what other people have told you.
I spoke to a gentleman who studied the whole thing for years, and he explained to me that Muslims are allowed to lie as long as it promotes Islam.
Oh, yeah, we heard this one last night. This was also rebutted by Will. That one's BS, too.
Back that up, gentleman over here who says he knows it all.
Can you recap that one from last night, Will? Because we're here. This is the second night in a row someone's made this claim.
Yes, the concept that is
promote Islam. As long as it promotes Islam, you're allowed to lie.
Okay, we heard you. Go ahead, Will Coley.
Yeah, I heard your accusation. Unfortunately, the scholarly
like a
does
cop,
not back
actually.
That up.
They're allowed to lie in order to get you arrested.
That's true. Yeah, the cops
are
allowed
to lie. It's much
more likely
that you're going to be lied to by a cop.
Go ahead, Will. Sorry.
The scholarly on this is specifically dealing with people who are in duress under a direct threat to their life or property. So if you were to come to me, if the gentleman on the phone were to come to me and say, "I'm here to kill all the Muslims. Are you Muslim?" I have a right to say, "No, I'm not a Muslim." Mm. Much like the Muslims who protected Jews during the Nazi times when they were going through North Africa trying to round up Jews in North Africa, when the Nazis would come and knock on the door, "Hey, you got any Jews in there?" And the Muslim said no, because he was protecting the life of the Jew, not considered a lie in the same sense as me telling
Right, in the same way that if somebody says,
"Drink vodka,"
yeah, give me this is a stick up. Give me all your money, and you only give them what's in your wallet, but not what's in, you know, your shoe or whatever. Then that's, you know, still not necessarily a bad.
Well,
thing.
The idea is because the preservation of human life is paramount. So if you're put in a position where you have your choice between starving to death or eating a pork chop, you're required by Islam to eat the pork chop because that is what will sustain your life. If you are put in a position where there's a gun to your head and you're about to have your family or your life taken, and you're asked a question, is this your faith? Is this what you believe? You tell them no, I don't believe because of the fact that it's preserving your life.
I'd say that's one difference with Islam and Christianity.
That doesn't mean that
Christianity basically says that you may not say otherwise. You must say that you're a Christian.
Hey. Yes, whereas Islam allows for the weakness of humanity, where not all of us have the strength to stand in the face of death and be a martyr. Some of us are afraid of death, and we have the ability to say, no, I'm not Muslim, because that is what's going to keep you from killing me. That doesn't mean that I can lie to you about what Islam teaches. That's shirk, and it's considered a major sin.
So, Dave in New Jersey, one more question for you here. This person that you're relying on who claims that they did all this studying, you know, is it possible that maybe they were wrong?
Possibly.
Yeah.
Possibly.
I would say when claims are being made about someone, you should go to the source. If somebody's claiming X, Y, and Z about Muslims, you should talk to a few Muslims and see what they have to say about it. So now you've heard from one. And Dave, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Will, do you want to stick with us? I think we got another call who has a question about Islam.
Sure.
All right. Stand by. More with Will Coley. He is from Muslims for Liberty. Muslims, the number four. Liberty.org is the website. And actually, you know what? I think, Will, you'd make a great talk show host. I did talk about if you moved up here to New Hampshire, I'd love to have you on Free Talk Live regularly. But, I mean, wouldn't it be cool to have like a Liberty Muslim talk show? I think that'd be cool.
I think it would get a lot of callers.
Oddly enough, I was a co-host of the first Tea Party radio show in the country, Tea Party Patriots Live on 660 AM in Orlando, Florida for about a year. It wasn't a Muslim specific show. It was the first Tea Party show in the U.S.
We should talk about this off
that
air.
Was years ago.
Hey, Will, stand by. We'll bring you back. We'll also see if we can clear up the internet connection as well. It's Ian and Mark in the studio with you here tonight on the live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live. We got a little bit more from John McAfee here tonight, and of course, whenever Will's on the line, it always, you know, people have questions about Muslims because they don't know. You can't rely on Fox News.
In some cases, they're just angry.
Yeah, you can't rely. Well, because they've heard lies.
Yeah,
they don't,
sure.
They don't know what the truth is. You can't rely on Fox News to give you honest, unbiased information.
You're allowed to lie to get better ratings.
855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. 855-450-3733. It's Free Talk Live. Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof form of money to the people, where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom and the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, October 11th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.85 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,156 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $249. Antiwar.com reports Israeli troops were out in force in the occupied West Bank and along the Gaza border fence attacking Palestinian protesters as the unrest in the territory continues to grow. Over the course of Friday, seven Palestinians were killed and 470 others were wounded nationwide, many of them critically. On Saturday morning, Israeli troops killed another five people, including two children in Gaza. Israel has been cracking down on unrest in the area around Jerusalem and the West Bank all week, following a terrorist attack with new restrictions on Arabs across the area and then moving militarily against protesters rallying against those restrictions. The West Bank was again the site of most of the casualties, with one killed in Hebron and 410 others wounded. The deaths overwhelmingly came from the Gaza Strip, which was previously not part of the latest military operations. On Saturday, however, reports of demonstrations along the border fence had the military reacting aggressively, opening fire on the demonstrators with live rounds, killing six and wounding 60. Many of the 60 wounded in Gaza were not expected to survive, as health officials say they were shot in the head and neck with sniper fire and gravely wounded. Among West Bank injuries, many of them were not likely to be fatal, with a lot of protesters shot with rubber bullets and 279 of the hospitalized recovering from exposure to tear gas. There were few reports of Israeli troops being wounded, but despite this, officials presented the various incidents as clashes. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports the Pentagon has temporarily barred the for-profit University of Phoenix from recruiting on military bases and using veteran tuition assistance amid an ongoing investigation into possible policy violations. The school, the nation's largest private university, is not allowed to enroll new military students under the Defense Department's Education Assistance Program. The Department of Defense indicated the violations include misusing trademarked United States military insignia and failing to get proper authorization when recruiting on military bases. A Pentagon spokesman cited reports of non-compliance by the school but would not provide more information. The Federal Trade Commission and California's Attorney General are also reviewing the school's recruiting practices. The Department of Justice and Department of Education are reportedly coordinating ongoing investigations. The University of Phoenix has more than 200,000 enrolled students, both civilian and military, in 29 locations in 17 states. A majority of the students attend classes online. The school has also come under fire as one of several for-profit universities being blamed for driving up outstanding student loan debt and college tuition cost.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports the U.S. Department of Defense will seek to make condolence payments to families of victims of a U.S. airstrike that hit a Doctors Without Borders hospital in Kunduz, Afghanistan, killing 22 people. Pentagon spokesman Peter Cook said in a statement, the Department of Defense believes it is important to address the consequences of the tragic incident at the Doctors Without Borders hospital in Kunduz, Afghanistan, adding the United States would also pay to repair the charity hospital. The medical charity is pressing for an international commission to investigate the possible war crime. Among those killed were 12 Doctors Without Borders staff. On Tuesday, Defense Secretary Ash Carter said the U.S. military deeply regretted the loss of life and was acknowledging its mistake and working to understand what went wrong. Carter said in a statement, the U.S. military takes the greatest care in our operation to prevent the loss of innocent life, and when we make mistakes, we own up to them. That's exactly what we're doing right now. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Now, how much money will all those closeted Republican convention goers bring into the city, Marie?
A lot. The average area prostitute normally makes around $200 to $300 a week, jerking off truck drivers behind the bus station.
I see.
Next week, they are expecting to make 30 times that amount, sucking off secretly gay Republicans.
Wow.
You figure the fact that these delegates are so repressed and filled with self-hatred,
yes,
they tend to like the filthiest, kinkiest sex acts imaginable.
Oh, that's
which
right.
Tends to cost more. The average well-adjusted gay man has no desire to smear fecal matter all over his partner. Face
no.
Or be beat up by him. But that is exactly the sort of thing that these repressed conservatives are willing to pay top dollar for.
Okay, as well as the services of transsexuals, I understand.
Yes. A lot of the Republicans repeatedly call the prostitutes faggots or
true.
Start crying after they've had sex with them.
I suppose the prostitutes are shoring up on their politics so they can talk to the Republicans.
Ha ha, Andrea, what do you think this is, Pretty Woman? They're just there to get
right. Thank you, Marie Byron.
Well, RNC's always a good time.
This is the Onion News Network.
It is Free Talk Live. You can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Millions of Facebook users around the world have no idea they're using the internet. Kind of a shocking study here. With you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark. And I've heard a statistic not too long ago that 90% of people believe that their intelligence is above average.
That's not possible, right?
No, it could be. Right. Well, you either get that joke or yeah. It was meant for you, right?
Oh, so that's a joke?
Well, it's a joke.
Okay.
It's funny.
I thought there was actually a survey where people said that.
No, there is a survey where people said where that was said.
Oh,
and
so it's not a joke.
It's funny or you don't get it and you weren't meant to.
Got it. Right, so it's real. It's not a joke then. But it's funny, real.
Okay, it's funny, real.
Yeah. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-3733.
Can a joke not be true?
I guess it could be, yeah. Anyway, we got Will Coley on the line with us here from the Muslims for Liberty at muslimsforliberty.org. That's Muslims, the number four, liberty.org. And as usual, he's actually calling to respond to somebody who brought up these claims about Muslims, which are usually misinformed. People, you know, they hear things, they have these people that they trust as purported experts, even though the people that are purported experts on Sharia law that they're trusting aren't actually Muslims. So obviously they haven't really done as much research as many Muslims have done on this topic. And Will Coley from Muslims for Liberty is well-researched. He really knows these issues and can explain very, very well what Sharia law is. And Sharia law, as my understanding, is a set of rules for Muslims, not for anyone else. And we've still got him with us here on Skype and on a new connection, I think. Will, are you with us, sir?
Yeah, I'm here. Is that a better connection?
I don't know. We'll see. It's a little janky, but we'll see how far we can get into this. Because, you know, whenever we have Will on the line, it just inevitably brings more people on the phones to talk to him. Because I think people are genuinely curious about this. They, you know, they don't know what the truth is about Sharia law, comma, Muslims, comma, Islam. And so I want to bring Dana on the line with us, or Dana, rather, is on the line in Michigan. You're on Free Talk Live with Will Coley from Muslims for Liberty.
Hi. Will, I came in when Dave called in, the last caller, so I'm at a disadvantage. Are you of Middle Eastern descent, or are you an American who is a convert, or were you born into it? I'm just curious.
I'm from East Tennessee originally. I converted to Islam about 8 years ago. I started studying Islam academically about 11 years ago, and started lecturing on Islam academically about 5 years ago.
Okay, I was just interested, because whether you're a convert, which is by choice, or born into it, like many people are in their faith, especially converts, I was always told by a very wise woman that people, not about Muslim faith, but just Christianity, those who are converts are usually the strongest Christians because they chose to be.
They know the most about it too, I think.
Right, because they're really, really devoted to it. And I don't disagree with that, but because you are a convert, of course you're not going to come and say anything bad. I don't care what you do with your life or practice, but I think for you to come on this show, and these guys have devoted their lives to liberty, and the people who listen to Mark and Ian feel the same way. And for you to put up this pretense that Sharia, it is the antithesis of what Mark and Ian are trying to do.
You don't get to speak for me, ma'am. I appreciate everything that Will has done. He is also a very liberty-oriented guy. He's come up to the Porcupine Freedom Festival here in New Hampshire on multiple occasions, has fed thousands of meals to people over those occasions through the goodness of his heart and charity, basically. He's a good guy, and I don't doubt...
His wife was there, too, and she could have escaped any time.
Okay. I don't doubt any of the words that are coming out of his mouth. I think he's done
fine,
this research.
And I'm not speaking for you. I'm saying what you guys claim to be standing for, that what the Sharia law is the antithesis of that. I'm not beating Will up. I'm not speaking.
But have you actually ever done any research on this beyond talking
actually,
to Fox
yes,
News?
Yes, I have.
Let Will
talking heads.
Yes.
Okay. Well, hold on. If you've done some research,
now wait a minute. Stop.
Dana, you've had a chance to go on here for a moment. I think it's fair that Will can respond to what you've said.
I want Will.
I'm going to put her on hold because I don't want to hear shouting. Go ahead, Will.
You've done some research on Sharia, or at least that's your claim. So what I will do is, I'll just ask you two very simple introductory questions about Sharia. There are five foundations of law called the Maqsad. Do you know any of the Maqsad? There are five foundations of jurisprudence called the Qa'idah. Do you know any of the Qa'idah? Because if you're claiming that you have expertise or knowledge on Sharia and you have no ability to list any of these, it would literally be the same as saying you're an expert on the Constitution, but when challenged to list amendments of the Bill of Rights, had no answer.
All right, go ahead, Dana.
Okay, two things. First of all, I said I wasn't beating you up, Will, and you just said, you put words in my mouth and said I claim to be an expert. I never claimed to be anything. I'm saying that you're purporting things about some things about Sharia that you're saying I don't disagree with, but you're picking and choosing. And as far as you, Ian, don't accuse me, as you said, I shouldn't put words in your mouth. Don't tell me where I'm getting my information from.
Where are you getting it from? Academic research. You did academic research, but yet you can't answer his question about some of the most basic facets of Sharia law.
I first addressed two things, one to Will, that I wasn't beating him up, and you not telling me where I'm getting my news from or my information.
Okay, but you can't answer his questions. I heard what you did.
Sharia law, Will, and I don't doubt that you're not a good person, but a lot of good people get sandbagged by things that they only see the good of, or they're only told the good of. You know the whole basis of all of this, the whole basis of this faith. Make sure when you do your research on Sharia law, also include how all of this started from Muhammad. Do you know who that man was? That was not a prophet that you guys are following. That man was 40 years old approximately 40, 42, before he even found his so-called God. he did horrific things to human beings, to women and children. And the only reason he found God and became a preacher, like most of these snake oil salesmen do, is because he failed at every single enterprise.
Thanks for the call, Dana. Those are some pretty serious allegations, Will Coley, from Muslims for Liberty. Yeah. Can you respond?
Well, first of all, before Muhammad received his prophethood, he was a very successful merchant. He was known as Al-Sadiq, which means the truthful. There was a huge argument among the tribes in Mecca about who would – they had to tear down a temple and rebuild a temple. And there was a huge argument over who would set the cornerstone for the rebuilding of the temple, because it was this very honorable thing among the tribes. And they didn't go outside. They went to Muhammad because he was known for being honest, equitable, truthful.
And a murderer, right?
Unbiased.
A killer.
You know, he was known for these things. The people who hated him, the people who were trying to kill off the Muslims, would still bring him their property and ask him to hold it for them, while at the same time they were trying to undermine his message and have him killed. I mean, that has to tell you about the trustworthiness of a man. Is if you're trying to undermine their message and harming their followers, but you will still bring them your property to watch while you're out of town because you know it will be safe with them, you know, that's not the kind of man that the woman was just describing. Yet this is how the people who knew him who weren't Muslim even described him during the time of his life.
You know, there's a Christian that converted somewhere around the middle of his life. His name was originally it was Saul, and then it was Paul. And, you know, he did some terrible things before he converted, too. Christians don't seem to be holding him to the same standard.
People can change, right? Free Talk Live.
Ever wish you had a business that ran itself, put money in your pocket, and you didn't have to go to work? If I could turn your current life into that business, then list it in the right systems that put money in your pocket, so potentially, you didn't have to go to work. Is that something you might be interested in? Credit Success Secrets Revealed is exactly that. We help you document your life as a business. We place that data in the right systems to trigger automatic personal and business credit that works. We teach you how to get business funding to buy assets that put money in your pocket. Credit Success Secrets Revealed works 100% of the time, no matter your situation. It's as easy as following simple directions. We practically fill it out for you. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people get cash in their hands right now. Call 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or go to CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com.
My name is Bill Bonner, and I'm the president of the largest private news and research network in the world. And I paid for this airtime because I have an important message to the American people. There's a change coming that the government isn't telling you about. This change has deep implications for life in America, from where you shop to the doctors you visit and the family you want to protect. Look, I've made predictions like this before. Thing is, I was right then too. A few years ago, I warned that housing prices would collapse. They did. Before that, I warned that dot-com companies would crash. They did. Those who listened had a chance to save themselves. But this has nothing to do with the stock market. This will affect us all.
You can watch the video for free right now by going to disappearingwealth.com. Again, that's disappearingwealth.com.
If you are successful at what you do, whether you're a doctor, a lawyer, a business owner, or you have a great career, you understand the concept of protecting yourself. Well, are you protecting yourself, your family, and your assets with quality term life insurance? Consider these possible rates. A man age 45, non-tobacco user, could obtain $1 million of coverage for as little as $75 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 10 years. We specialize in policies of $500,000 and above.
A man age 50, non-tobacco user, may be able to obtain $500,000 of coverage for as little as $115 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 20 years. We have great rates for smokers, too. Call the Term Lifeline now. 800-872-0403, 800-872-0403, 800-872-0403.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us here on the radio at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And as the show has done on a few occasions now, maybe even more than a few over the last year or two, it's turned into Ask a Muslim Night here on Free Talk Live. Whenever we bring Will Coley on the line, he's so well-informed, so knowledgeable on the topic of Islam, because he's into that. He's been a Muslim for 8 years. He's been studying it for 11. On an academic level, and he sounds like he knows it on an academic level. And so there's a lot of misinformation out there, which results in a lot of people having honest questions, some having hostile questions, but some having honest questions about this. And we'll take any of those here on Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. If you need to protect yourself online, and you should have a need for that, because if you don't take steps, then you are completely at risk from all manner of prying and spying. Number one, from your internet service provider that is likely logging everything you do online and maybe even selling that information or giving it over to the government. You can stop that right now by going to proxpn.com and getting started with ProXPN. It's a virtual private network that encrypts your online data. Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux, whatever your operating system, you're good to go. When you use code FTL50, you'll get 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of your account when you buy their annual account at proxpn.com. Again, that code is FTL, like Free Talk Live, FTL50. But that's not the only deal from ProXPN that we're offering you. If you have Bitcoin, you can get the best deal possible on ProXPN. You go to proxpn.com/amp. That's A-M-P, like advertise, market, and promote. Like the Free Talk Live AMP program, because ProXPN is on board with the whole Liberty thing, which is cool. You can go to proxpn.com/amp, then buy for less than $50 worth of Bitcoin. You'll get 2 years worth of ProXPN, which is an amazing discount, and $5 of your purchase price will go to the Free Talk Live AMP program to help us spread the ideas of freedom. So go to proxpn.com/amp, take advantage of that Bitcoin offer, or if you still have a credit card and that's what you want to use, use code FTL50 to get that 50% off deal that we have discussed. Let's continue here. We still have Will Coley with us on kind of a janky connection, but we're going to keep going with it here. We tried to clear it up a little bit. Will, are you still there?
Yeah, I'm here, guys.
All right, excellent. It's actually sounding pretty good right now. So, right back into your calls and thoughts. Let's go first to Benny listening, or Bernie, excuse me. Bernie is in South Carolina. You're on Free Talk Live.
Thank you. We spoke about some of these matters yesterday. I don't know if that means I can't speak tonight.
You get one call per night on Free Talk Live. So go ahead with your, if you have a question for Will.
You're very kind. Mr. Cooley, you sound like a very intelligent and studied man, and I only disagree with you to the point that I do not believe you can speak for all billion of the faithful on this planet.
Of course not.
Would you not?
I don't speak for any other individual than my own self and what the texts themselves state. And I've honestly, you know, on more than one occasion, I think Ian's actually heard me say this from the stage. Nothing I say is original. I literally regurgitate the teachings and the words of scholars from the 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, and 13th centuries in Persia, Egypt, Baghdad, North Africa. None of the ideas that I have, none of the things that I talk about are myself. I'm quoting books that were written hundreds of years ago.
Yeah, you always cite what you're quoting. You always cite the scholars whenever you mention
those
things.
People who are far, far beyond me in knowledge and in scholarly. People that put my amount of knowledge to shame are the people who I quote. And, you know, these aren't my words. It's not my opinion. And just because there are other Muslims who don't share my opinion, it doesn't change the fact that this is what the texts state. And that's what really matters. If we're going to talk about what a religion or what a legal system encourages, allows, or pushes, then we need to do that from a standpoint of what the texts state, not what individuals or governments carry out.
My source, when I was saying about non-believers not being allowed to own real estate, was based on the experience I had with the company that I worked for back in the 80s that did business in the kingdom in Kuwait. They were not allowed to purchase land. They had to go through resident middlemen to do business.
That sounds like a government problem, not an issue with what
I would respectfully submit that said government decisions were based on said government officials' interpretation of their faith.
Certainly the interpretation, that's true. Thanks, Bernie, for your call.
The problem with that is when you have a dictatorial government or a patrilineal monarchy like you have in Kuwait and the other Gulf states like UAE and Saudi, just the very existence of that type of a government is a violation of the command of the Prophet Muhammad, who said that no man is more qualified to rule over another simply because of who his father is. And that's the type of government that these countries have. So when you start, when the very beginning and basis of your government is something that is outside the realms of what's Islamically permissible, from that point forward, you should just look at what they do and assume that it's not Islamically permissible, because the very first step is already a violation.
You should also consider assuming, like, it's at least be open to the idea that somebody who, say, doesn't live in one of those countries has taken the time, the energy, the incredible amount of expense that it might take to move from one of those countries here, may not think that those countries and the way they run things are so awesome and may not want to replicate it here.
Well, that's why we have activists that work in these countries that translate Muslims for Liberty work into the local indigenous language. They pass out paper copies of it, sometimes in a manner that's somewhat secretive and incognito, depending on the country that they're in. But you do have Muslims that are in these countries that they are against the governments that are there. They see the fact that the governments, the way that they are put together, is not appropriate. They have no Islamic legitimacy whatsoever.
And this is, you know, sort of the equivalent of what happens in the United States, where most of the people who get elected here would call themselves some sort of variant of Christian. And, of course, Jesus was, you could argue, a very strong against the government of that time. And so, you know, there's some sort of paper, I think, on the internet calling Jesus an anarchist and citing Bible verses to back up that claim. I don't know if that's true or not, but it's certainly true. He was no fan of the government at that time.
I can assure you that there are people that believe that Jesus is a Democrat, too.
There's a very strong precedent in Islam in general for the distrust of the government. As a matter of fact, the greatest scholars, like the people who are viewed as like the greatest scholars of Islamic history, one thing that they hold in common was that they were oppressed, kidnapped, tortured in some way by the government of their time. Imam Malik, it was said that he prayed with his hands by his side because he couldn't lift his arms up to cross them across his breast because of the fact that he'd been tortured by the political
political leadership of his time for teaching a version of Islam that wasn't in keeping with what the stage. Same thing with Imam al-Qadhafi, Imam Abu Hanifa.
Will Coley, can you stand by? We've got almost a full load of calls here. They want to talk to you, apparently. So,
sure.
I'm going home.
More with Ask a Muslim. I don't know why you would do that, Mark. I think this is really interesting discussion here. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. This is Free Talk Live.
The human body is more than 60% water. Your brain and muscles are 75% water. And your blood is 92% water. Water is vital to your body, and alkalizing your water is the key to keep it running at its best. AlkaVision Plasma pH drops keep your entire body healthy, boosts energy, promotes weight loss, and even fights cancer. Call 800-518-7615 or go to alkavision.com to find out more. That's alkavision.com.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, Neocash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Silvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, The Seditious Sirens, The Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, Tech Guru Brian Sovereign, Cop Blocker J.P. Freeman, New Mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand Minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallowkeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nestle Tollhouse Morsels, helping you create special moments and memories your family will cherish forever. Visit us at tollhouse.com. You may bake for birthdays and holidays, but why stop there? Sweeten up the rest of the year by designating monthly dessert days. Treat your family to one of their favorites or surprise them with something new. Either way, you'll create a tradition everyone will love. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace Love Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.fm Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Hey, It's Free Talk Live, the live Sunday edition of the program. You can dial in toll-free. We might be able to get you on here if you want to talk to a Muslim with Free Talk Live. Ian and Mark here in the studio tonight, and Will Coley from the Muslims for Liberty at Muslims, the number 4, liberty.org, is on the line with us, generously giving of his time here tonight. He wasn't planned as a guest on the show or anything like that. There was some guy calling in, making claims about Sharia law, and actually Daryl sent Will a message suggesting he give a call in, and he did that, and now...
See, I like the idea that Will's listening to the show and just calls in whenever anybody says something.
Well, he was out shopping for diapers. I mean, not everybody can listen to every single moment of Free Talk Live, as much as we might like that to be the case. And, Will, thank you for sharing extra time with us here tonight, because as soon as you called in and started to rebut some of the misinformation that was being touted by one of our callers, inevitably, more people called with all kinds of questions. So we've got them waiting to talk, and you can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. If you call us on Skype, we can't conference you with Will, so if you have a question for Will, you do need to call the toll-free lines at 855-450-3733. Coming up here in Keene, New Hampshire, Keenevention is right around the corner. We're about 3 weeks away, just under 3 weeks. At this point, it's October 30th through November 1st. It's a great opportunity to come up, check out New Hampshire, and in the fall, in a beautiful time of year. It's going to be just past the peak, which peak of leaf peeping season.
It's right now.
It's looking very, very pretty outside right now, but there'll still be some nice trees probably by the time Keenevention gets rolling here in
there'll
a couple
some.
Weeks. So you can come up here and join with dozens of other liberty-loving people at the smallest convention in New Hampshire. There are some great get-togethers like the Porcupine Freedom Festival during the summer, where you can actually meet Will Coley. He's there, I think, every single year serving food out of his tent site. And then, of course, there's the Liberty Forum, which the Free State Project puts on during the wintertime. These are also great events. I recommend you come for those. But if you want to check out New Hampshire during the fall, Keenevention is your best bet. And it's super affordable. It's $60, gets you in for the entire weekend, or you can pay with Bitcoin. So go to keenevention.info. You can learn more about the event there. It's a lot of fun. I enjoy putting it on for folks, even though there's some level of work involved on the back end. So go to keenevention.info, check out more about it, and get registered. We'll look forward to seeing you in a few weeks. And Will Coley, thanks for sticking on with us here, as a lot of people have a lot of questions about being a Muslim, the Islamic religion and belief system. So are you ready to continue?
Sure.
Excellent. We're
gonna
go to Charles in Nevada. He's listening to KKFT on FM. Hello, Charles. You're in Reno. Go ahead.
How you guys doing?
Hey, great. Go ahead with your thoughts, Charles. You're on the air.
Yeah, I just had a couple of questions, and I know this gentleman is an expert.
Let's keep it to one. I apologize, Charles. We're gonna have to keep it to one question, just because there are a lot of people with questions here.
Well, then I have one main question then, and what that would be is, especially with everything that's going on in the world now, especially with everything that happened in the past with the rewriting of the Quran, all the murder that was involved, the Sunni-Shia separation, the Sunni-Shia for thousands of years now have been massacring each other, with everything and, people going around the world right now, decapitating women, children, Christians, and yelling Allahu Akbar, how is it that Muslims can say that it is a religion of peace? And that's my question.
Thanks, Charles, for your call tonight. Your thoughts on that? There was a lot all boxed up in that one question. Go ahead, Will.
Religion of peace.
Religion of peace. Well, I myself am a peaceful person. I know the Quran specifically tells me to consume my neighbor's wealth, not unjustly, but only to commence trade by mutual consent. So I know that economically I'm a voluntarist. I know that I'm told to observe the rights of my neighbor, be they Muslim or non-Muslim, and that the rights of the neighbor over me, according to God, are so great that Muhammad actually thought that he would be told to let Muslims inherit, that neighbors could inherit property from Muslims. So I don't really see where that's not a peaceful way of life. If your neighbor has a right to life, has a right to religious liberty, has a right to
his intellect, has his right to protect his family and a right to his property according to the foundations of law and Sharia, then protecting those is being a peaceful person.
Do you feel any responsibility for other people in other countries that are doing horrifying things that call themselves Muslims?
I'm not a communist, no, not particularly.
I don't think Christians really should feel responsible for the murderers who call themselves Christians.
I thought it was really funny that the guy called in and talked about, when you juxtapose Islam versus Christianity, you can find historically a lot of horrifying crap that's happened through Christianity. Has the Bible been rewritten? Yes, it has. By the way, the Quran being rewritten, what does he mean when he says that?
Because
it's my understanding about the Quran is that at the very least, the Quran is the single, this is the original.
Well, now there is a discussion of around the time of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, and I'm not sure if this is what he's alluding to or not, but one of the things that was confessed by one of the British spies who worked directly with the Al-Saud and Abdul Wahhab groups was that there was a desire to rewrite the Quran and the great works of Islamic scholarly, like to figure out a way to change what these books said and get new versions out. But this was back at like the 1800s. During the time that the UK was trying to destabilize the Ottomans in the lead up to World War I and all of this kind of stuff. But one of the things that the British realized was that at least at that point, that was not something that would be possible. The idea was to destroy all of the Islamic historic artifacts, like everything that connected Islam to history needed to go. And like the Prophet's Mosque and the Kaaba and the Haram, like all of these historic landmarks needed to go. And they weren't able to get rid of them all at one time. But now the Saudis were put into power in 1913. And from 1913 to today, almost all of those Islamic artifacts have been wiped out in the Arabian Peninsula. The home where Muhammad was born, the home where his wives lived, the home where his mother lived, all of these different, the home of Abu Bakr, the home of the Sahaba. When the Wahhabis first invaded Mecca, they tried to destroy the Prophet's mosque. They destroyed the cemetery where Muhammad and all of his companions were buried. So that's the only thing that I can think of that he would be alluding to as far as like a new version, like a rewritten Quran.
Well, now, certainly there are translations of the Quran, right? So there's the original written in Arabic, I presume. But
there's not that many translations. I mean, usually the translations are right next to the Arabic, and Muslims are encouraged to learn Arabic.
That's true.
Like, yeah. Christians, they don't have that. There aren't the original documents when it comes to Christianity.
Unfortunately, though, most of the Qurans that go out in English are going to people that don't understand Arabic. They don't know how to read it in the original language, and therefore they don't know whether or not what's in the text is true. PBS actually did a documentary on the fact that Saudi Arabia is so well known for purposely mistranslating the Quran and other Islamic works that PBS did a documentary about it.
Wow.
The Saudi Arabian government subsidizes printing presses all throughout the world, and that they add things to the text that do not appear in the original Arabic.
That happened with the King James Version, too, of the Bible. There were additions specifically intending to promote the idea of a Trinitarian God and these sorts of things. So, your holy text being, bastardized in some way, shape, or form certainly isn't new.
Will, you got time for one more segment?
Sure.
Stand by. Will Coley from Muslims for Liberty. That's Muslims the number 4 and liberty.org. Our toll-free number here is 855-453, 855-450-3733. This is Free Talk Live's Live Sunday Edition.
Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof money to the people where it belongs.
Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom in the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral! Don't take on the IRS alone! I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely!
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral!
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Hey, this is Free Talk Live, and that means, of course, you can call in, bring up anything that you want. And that is what has happened here tonight. Somebody called in about allegations regarding Sharia law, and what do you know? We've got ourselves a Muslim on the line to talk about it, which has resulted in a avalanche of phone calls. If you're trying to get in right now, you'll find the lines are completely busy, so don't bother to call at this point. If you're already on hold, stand by. We'll do our best to get you on the air. It's Ian and Mark here in the studio with you. And of course, we do this live 7 nights a week. So if you didn't get in with your topic tonight, maybe it was something completely different, you can call any night of the week, of course.
If this was the 1680s in the Boston, the Massachusetts Bay Colony, then Ask a Quaker would get just as many Puritans to call in.
So we got Will Coley back on the line with us here from Muslims, the number 4, liberty.org. I know you wanted to make a short statement before we continue with the call, so keep it short because I do want to get as many folks on as possible.
Yeah, well, one of the people had said something about my education and my learning and that about being told, you know, only what I was supposed to be told type things. But the reason why I initially started, I went to school to learn how to arbitrate between disputing parties based on Islamic jurisprudence. Like, that was what I went to school for. So that the way it works is it's not really appropriate for a Muslim from Syria or from Saudi Arabia or from Kuwait to come to America and try to tell Muslims in America how to live Islam the right way for a Muslim that's from America. They can't arbitrate, you know, differences between Muslims who are born here and raised here because they have no cultural perspective for what would be appropriate and what wouldn't be appropriate. What is allowed in some cultures is a social faux pas in others. So there was a need that I felt I could fill by studying Islamic jurisprudence and Islamic law. Of now there's about 7 or 8 of us, I guess, that are born here in the U.S. All of the others are far more qualified than myself. I'm still just a student. But there are about 8 of us now in the U.S. who are born here, who have studied Islamic jurisprudence and who interpret Islam and Islamic jurisprudence from the perspective of Americans, from the perspective of American culture, from people who were born in this country, raised in this country, raised as non-Muslims in this country.
Thank you for that service. Let's bring Joe on the line in North Carolina in the Asheville area, listening to WWNC. Hello, Joe. You're on with Will Coley.
Hi. Thanks for having me
sure.
on. That was my first time ever calling a radio show.
Welcome.
Thank you. I listened to you in Nevada also. So I had asked about a few personal anecdotal stories to mention to your visitor today. I briefly attended Muslim meetings with my dad in high school, but I'm a Christian now. Anyway, one, you should keep your questions to one.
Yep.
My husband was a dental professor in San Antonio, Texas, so we had Saudi Arabian dental students come. So I knew some wives and some of those American women who liked to hang out with them because they were Saudi. I guess they were the best Muslims. Anyway, they had to have 2 entrances to their home. And I remember a cover of an Architectural Digest had a photo of a huge home in a Muslim country with 2 entrances.
2 entrances, meaning one for the man, one for the woman?
Right. That was one question I had.
Thank you, Joe, for your call tonight. Will, your thoughts on that?
Well, yeah, that's actually the not for a home, but for a mosque, that's the sunnah, is that there's 1 entrance for men and 1 entrance for women because the interior of the masjid isn't physically segregated. It's not supposed to be physically segregated by a wall or anything like that, but the men pray together and the women pray together. This is something that was actually practiced pretty commonly in Christian communities here in Appalachia where I
really?
Live. Now you can find churches in Cades Cove. They have 2 entrances, one for men and one for women. And these were Baptist churches. So this was a pretty common practice among religious traditions when Islam came about.
You go back far enough and you'll find that.
They also put the kids in. When I was in church, they had the kids' church thing,
yeah, but
too.
Kids are just annoying, Ian. Yeah. That's why.
And let's continue here. We've got Scott on the line in South Carolina listening to WTMA. Scott, you're on with Will Coley from Muslims for Liberty.
Thank you.
Go ahead, sir.
Will, you sound like a decent and earnest guy. I'm sure you are. And you may have touched on what I'm asking about when we came back from the break. You mentioned lecturing. Are you ever, do you ever address primarily Muslim audiences? And can you address these cultural things like cab drivers not picking up people with service animals or the honor killings or the genital mutilation? And do you get pushback, if you have, do you get pushback from the Muslim community?
Okay. Thanks, Scott, for the
call. Here in the U.S., I would say I do get pushback from the Muslim community, but more of a political nature because of the fact that we embrace libertarianism and we require Muslims to validate their political opinions with Islam. And Islam sees income taxes as oppression. It's not considered legal under Sharia to tax someone's income directly. So that's the main pushback that we get, because we deal mainly with Muslims that are here in the U.S. Now, I have had some more extreme Muslims that we have done debates online with more extreme Muslims. And usually what ends up happening is they'll acquiesce that theologically and, you know, textually my argument is correct. But then they always refer back to this idea that because of modernity, we need to add these new rules to the religion that don't have any textual basis, basically usually to prevent a person from having to use their own, you know, ability to resist things, you know, to their own will. You know what I'm saying?
Basically saying that because it's hard to resist income taxes, it's okay not to resist income taxes.
It's more like, because it's hard for me not to look at women when I go to the mosque, even though I'm supposed to be paying attention to the imam. So we need to put a wall up between the men and the women so that I'm not tempted to look at the women, because self-control is hard. So let's just take away the fact that I have to control myself and add these things that aren't a part of the faith.
He did mention genital mutilation. I think it's important to point out there are plenty of religions, including Christians, who mutilate the genitals of their children, specifically the baby boys, with circumcision.
Well, genital mutilation is mutilation is a North African issue.
No, it happens in the United States. Circumcisions happen a lot here in the United States, and that is absolutely genital mutilation.
To compare female genital mutilation,
I'm not comparing them, Mark. I'm calling it what it is. It is genital mutilation. What happens to baby boys all across the United States?
But let's look at the issue of female genital mutilation.
I don't want to look at that. It's a horrible issue.
It isn't a Muslim issue. It is a geographic issue. It's
okay,
an
fine.
African issue.
But I want to know what the Muslim perspective is on circumcision.
Eritrea, well, there is a ruling that states, and it's, you know, there are lots of opinions again in Islam. There is a legal ruling by a renowned scholar that states that a parent should allow the child to make the decision for themselves when they get older, kind of like in the Jewish tradition. Some Jews will wait until the time of the bar mitzvah, you know, when you're old enough to make that decision for yourself before the decision is made to make a circumcision.
So there are
rulings that state that that's the way that it should be. With female genital mutilation, again, it's a geographic issue. Eritrea and Ethiopia are both Christian majority countries, and they also have like 70% and 80% of the women in their countries who have suffered female genital mutilation.
So Christians, everybody in that country is more likely to mutilate genitals, is what you're saying.
It's a cult. Well, even like the local indigenous tribes, and that's where it came from. Mm-hmm. It was an indigenous tribal custom that carried over when these people converted to these new religions later on in history.
Murray is on the line in North Carolina in the Asheville area, listening to WWNC. Go ahead, Murray. You're on. On Ask a Muslim with Will Coley on Free Talk Live.
Howdy.
Whoa, little loud there, Murray. Just back away from your phone, if you would, a little bit.
All righty, then.
Thank you, sir. Go ahead.
I'm just curious how a feller from Eastern Tennessee, and I'm from Western North Carolina, buys into this Muslim stuff when he ought to be out in the mountains hunting ramps and trout fishing.
You do hunt, don't you, Will? You've done that before, right?
And I know what ramps are, too. We actually have a ramp hunt that's about 45 miles southeast of here, down by Athens.
So clearly you can be a hunter and a Muslim both.
Well, yeah, there's nothing in Islam that says that I have to give up my Appalachian culture and heritage. The only thing I really stopped doing the only real big difference was I stopped drinking. But the family, the regard for family and family closeness, and, you know, you do whatever you can to make your mama and your daddy happy and to take care of them and to take care of your children, you know, that down home, old fashioned values that I grew up with. I mean, my father is 80 years old, you know, so I grew up with this. And that was part of what drew me to Islam, was the fact that those values were specifically advocated for in the religious tradition.
Will Coley, always fascinating and informative. Thanks for taking extra time out tonight just on a whim to get on here with us and talk to folks. And that's Muslims, the number 4, liberty.org. That's his website. If you didn't get on tonight, that's okay. We do a show every single night, so join us tomorrow. Meantime, at freetalklive.com.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. you can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveatpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Friday, gold is $1 higher at $1,155 per ounce. Silver is up 14 cents at $15.89 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $244. We are seeing the first signs of a return of silver supply to the market. We have silver rounds and eagles back in stock. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, October 11th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.85 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,156 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $249. Antiwar.com reports Israeli troops were out in force in the occupied West Bank and along the Gaza border fence attacking Palestinian protesters as the unrest in the territory continues to grow. Over the course of Friday, seven Palestinians were killed and 470 others were wounded nationwide, many of them critically. On Saturday morning, Israeli troops killed another five people, including two children in Gaza. Israel has been cracking down on unrest in the area around Jerusalem and the West Bank all week, following a terrorist attack with new restrictions on Arabs across the area and then moving militarily against protesters rallying against those restrictions. The West Bank was again the site of most of the casualties, with one killed in Hebron and 410 others wounded. The deaths overwhelmingly came from the Gaza Strip, which was previously not part of the latest military operations. On Saturday, however, reports of demonstrations along the border fence had the military reacting aggressively, opening fire on the demonstrators with live rounds, killing six and wounding 60. Many of the 60 wounded in Gaza were not expected to survive, as health officials say they were shot in the head and neck with sniper fire and gravely wounded. Among West Bank injuries, many of them were not likely to be fatal, with a lot of protesters shot with rubber bullets and 279 of the hospitalized recovering from exposure to tear gas. There were few reports of Israeli troops being wounded, but despite this, officials presented the various incidents as clashes. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports the Pentagon has temporarily barred the for-profit University of Phoenix from recruiting on military bases and using veteran tuition assistance amid an ongoing investigation into possible policy violations. The school, the nation's largest private university, is not allowed to enroll new military students under the Defense Department's Education Assistance Program. The Department of Defense indicated the violations include misusing trademarked United States military insignia and failing to get proper authorization when recruiting on military military bases. A Pentagon spokesman cited reports of non-compliance by the school but would not provide more information. The Federal Trade Commission and California's Attorney General are also reviewing the school's recruiting practices. The Department of Justice and Department of Education are reportedly coordinating ongoing investigations. The University of Phoenix has more than 200,000 enrolled students, both civilian and military, in 29 locations in 17 states. A majority of the students attend classes online. The school has also come under fire as one of several for-profit universities being blamed for driving up outstanding student loan debt and college tuition cost.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports the U.S. Department of Defense will seek to make condolence payments to families of victims of a U.S. airstrike that hit a Doctors Without Borders hospital in Kunduz, Afghanistan, killing 22 people. Pentagon spokesman Peter Cook said in a statement, "The Department of Defense believes it is important to address the consequences of the tragic incident at the Doctors Without Borders hospital in Kunduz, Afghanistan," adding the United States would also pay to repair the charity hospital. The medical charity is pressing for an international commission to investigate the possible war crime. Among those killed were 12 Doctors Without Borders staff. On Tuesday, Defense Secretary Ash Carter said the U.S. military deeply regretted the loss of life and was acknowledging its mistake and working to understand what went wrong. Carter said in a statement, "The U.S. military takes the greatest care in our operation to prevent the loss of innocent life, and when we make mistakes, we own up to them. That's exactly what we're doing right now." This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
It was a big night for music's hottest acts, especially for Lord Chillingworth. In a shocking upset, the young artist took home the spookiest Halloween sound effect album Grammy for Creepy Night in Halloween Manor. Music blogger Ty Vaughn is here. Ty, what a shocker.
Lord Chillingworth's track, Man Being Boiled Alive While Chains Rattle in a Dungeon, was crazy spooky. It was everywhere this year. Haunted houses, Halloween stores, nighttime hayrides. Anywhere you look, people were getting the willies from this album.
But a lot of people thought Grammy darling Dr.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at lrn.fm.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A-plus by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallowkeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Instead of just listening, you can also watch. See the Liberty Radio Network's Keene, New Hampshire-based live shows via our studio cam at cam.lrn.fm. Plus, you'll still be able to listen to the Liberty Radio Network via the cam feed in high quality 24/7, even when there's no live show being produced in our Keene studio. But wait, there's more. Our chat room is built into the cam page so you can interact with other listeners online. Listen, watch, and chat, all free at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Friday, gold is $1 higher at $1,155 per ounce. Silver is up 14 cents at $15.89 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $244. We are seeing the first signs of a return of silver supply to the market. We have silver rounds and eagles back in stock. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm. The latest edition of The Tom Woods Show is next on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. Get more at tomwoodsradio.com.
The Tom Woods Show, episode 508.
Prepare to set fire to the index card of allowable opinion. Your daily dose of liberty education starts here, The Tom Woods Show.
Don't let opportunity pass you by. The internet is handing you opportunities on a silver platter. With Code School, you can learn a skill that's in heavy demand in your spare time, namely web technologies and web development, and learn it enjoyably and cheaply. Get your free account at tomwoods.com/code. Welcome to another episode of The Tom Woods Show. We had a wonderful event at the Mises Circle in Dallas last weekend. We had a whole bunch of people there who got in for free because of the offer right here on the show. If you were a listener and you wanted to be at that event, you didn't have to pay the $95 entrance fee. And I didn't promote that on social media or through my newsletter or anywhere other than through the spoken word on the show to make sure we're talking about actual listeners. So listeners got that great benefit, and what a wonderful time we had. What I want to do for you now is play the talk that I gave on that subject, on political correctness, because that was the topic of the event. And in particular, I was talking about the worldview of the politically correct movement, which is that when you have differences in outcomes between groups, this can only mean that something sinister is at work. So if you have differences in incomes or job placement or whatever, this means something sinister is afoot. There's so-called discrimination, and discrimination leads to poverty and so on and so forth. And what I show in this talk is how absurdly simplistic a view that is. And what I'm trying to say, and I say it sometimes maybe in a way that's too subtle, you'll hear it if you're paying attention, but I want to make clear in here that if we're talking about, for example, black Americans, and we say that black Americans are underrepresented in, let's say, college professors, it's not correct to say that that's because of racism, because the correct question is, how many black Americans have PhDs in the relevant fields? So if you want to say there's a problem and we want to get more blacks into different types of occupations, well, the question becomes, get them the qualifications. Get them the relevant degree first. So, in other words, it's not enough to point fingers at the universities who would, of course, kill their own grandmothers in order to get more blacks on the faculty. I mean, of course, they all are desperate for that. But it's not their fault if there are only two black PhDs in mathematics in a given year when there were 500 PhDs awarded in mathematics, that sort of thing. That's what I'm talking about. So if you think there's something that can be done about it, you have to think about the when is that to be done. Is it to be done at the moment of the job interview? Is it to be done at the moment that a university is looking for a professor when the number of PhDs awarded, that's already occurred and there's nothing that can be done about that? So that's the sort of question that doesn't get raised. So I wanted to raise it here. I want to explain, you'll hear it in a probably I give it a lousy explanation in the talk, but I want to explain exactly what I'm talking about at the very beginning. Tom DiLorenzo gave a hilarious talk where part of it involved what's going on at Brown University, where they have safe rooms. If somebody shows up at Brown University and says something controversial, you can go into a safe room to be protected from these dangerous ideas. And in that safe room, this is not a joke, they have cookies, they have milk, they have coloring books. They have soothing music. They have blankets and pillows and so on and on. And Tom was saying, so if Tom Woods comes to your campus, you can rush right over to that safe room. So as soon as I got up to the podium, of course, I said to everybody, all right, off to your safe room. So that's what I was driving at there. All right, let's start the talk right now. And then afterward, I've got some fun little announcements I'll give you. So here we go. Hope you enjoy it.
Our first afternoon speaker needs little introduction, I'm sure, for most of you. Tom Woods. Do we have some of Tom Woods' show viewers, listeners here in the audience tonight? Show of hands. Wow. Welcome to all of you. This is the heavy Tom Woods crowd. You know all about his achievements, academic and otherwise, the books he's written. So instead, I'll just tout his latest venture, which is a joint effort with Bob Murphy, also an economist, in a new website and a new podcast called Contra Krugman. They're going to be doing, I believe, weekly podcasts, which are basically debunking Mr. Krugman, who writes a pop political blog for the New York Times called Conscience of a Liberal. So ContraKrugman.com is the website you need to check out. And Tom is our afternoon speaker. Tom?
Ladies and gentlemen, time to head off to your safe room. Don't say I didn't warn you. Before I get started today, and today, by the way, I'm going to cover all kinds of things that could make people uncomfortable. I'm going to talk about the so-called gender wage gap and argue that there really isn't one. I'm going to talk about all kinds of differences between all kinds of people and all kinds of groups. So fasten your seatbelts. But before I do that, I'd like to urge you to see these devices that you have, and we haven't hectored you about taking them out and turning them off. I'm actually going to hector you about taking them out and turning them on. Turn this on now, not just so you can tweet things about what I'm saying, but primarily because I'm going to give you a free book right now. It's called Bernie Sanders is Wrong. And it will be, this is a real book. It's a real e-book. It's about 150 pages. And it covers inequality, trade, renewable energy, should we be like Sweden, all these sorts of arguments that you hear. It's all in there. And I'm giving it to you because it'll actually be helpful for one of the topics I'm discussing today. So the way you get this book for free is simply to, and it comes in three formats. If you like Kindle, it'll give it to you that way. If you like PDF, EPUB, just text the name Bernie to the number 33444. So that's 33444. Text the name Bernie, and you will get the book, Bernie Sanders is Wrong. Amazing what technology makes possible. All right. I'll tell you in a minute what topic from there is going to be helpful for us this afternoon. What I want to talk about today is the narrative of oppression that underlies the whole political correctness movement. And this narrative holds certain things to be true, true to the point that you're not allowed to question them. Questioning them is not even considered to be a legitimate point of view. And if you should be so foolish as to question them, you will not be refuted. You will simply be hounded out of society. And we all know what I'm talking about. If you make some of the claims that I'll be making here today, you will not be met with a careful, sober, scholarly refutation. Instead, you will be hectored and called names, and your motives will be impugned. In a way, it is reminiscent of Marxism in that Marx would often say that an opponent of his was obviously simply a pawn of the bourgeois class. It was not necessary so much to refute this person. What we needed to do was unmask his class background, because then we would know